Welcome, welcome. Hey, hey, howdy. And there he went again. Welcome in, everybody.
Here, kitty. You're a pretty kitty. You got a pretty. Never mind.
Yeah.
Never mind.
Uh-huh. So soft. Soft kitty. Warm kitty.
Just a warm kitty.
Yeah. Little ball of fur.
It's a hairy kitty.
I gotta load that in now.
Sorry for the noise in the background. We still have family over.
Still got family there. That's all right.
Yeah. We had grandma, mom's great grandma.
Where's my? Oh, I don't have the regular soft kitty. Oh, just got the okay.
But we kicked her down the stairs real quick.
Hey, Tracy. It's not welcome in, everybody. So, welcome to Saturday night. We got to say hey to the chat. I got to scroll back up to the top, sure. And I can't get to the very top. I'm going to miss some people. So, Carlos has got a convention going on at the house.
Yeah, sorry, I'll mute.
So, welcome in, Kenneth H, Diz Noah, Nicole, Happy's Haunt. Let's see. Birdwell 2427. Hello, Sandy. Jan S. Disney. Welcome in, Jan. Good to see you. Stacy Rogers. Welcome. Fred O'Malley's here. Welcome in. Tigger Jeff, Sean W. Howdy, howdy. Gonna scroll on down. Disneyland fan. Welcome in. Good to see you. Ms. Disney fan. Good evening. Welcome. Welcome. Zanlax is here. Welcome in. Good to see you. Let's see. Vicky Gillespie, welcome in. Joy S. Hey, hey, Joy.
Hi.
There she is. There's her word for the evening. welcome in, David Bacco. Good to see you. Let's see. We got the cat waving now. let's see. Chris Dyes here. Welcome. Good to see you. I'm still scrolling. Stephen K., welcome in. Debbie Thunert. Good evening. Welcome. Welcome. Scroll on down and everybody's talking. Justin Sanudo. Hello, you handsome, handsome man. Let's see. John K., welcome. Good evening. Howdy. We're going to get there. Crystal K. is here as well. All the K clan. Welcome. Let's see. I'm going to scroll to the other one. K. will be welcome in. Dear Davey Bernfeld. Hello, Mama Davey. Murph, welcome. Good to see you. Stephen L. or Stephanie L. Good evening, Stephanie. I'm going to scroll up on this one. Mar in Memphis. Good evening, Mar. Steve Browning. Good evening. Welcome in. Pino Pete. Good to see you, sir. Nick in Virginia. Good evening. Corby Sinclair. Hello. And Marie Dreyer. Welcome in, Anne-Marie. Let's see. We got Vicky. We got Murph. We got Team Marie's Place, who's over there now. Let's see. Did I miss anybody? Kay Wilby, welcome. Still scrolling up. And there she is. The lovely, the beautiful, the talented. My snickerdoodle, the Daisy Duck to my Donald Duck. I thought up a new one. What was the new one I thought up? The Rogue to my Gambit. The Princess Leia to my Han Solo. The I was so excited for.
The cream to his puff.
The cream to my puff. The jelly to my donut. I don't know.
Or it could be my puff to my cream. But...
The cream to my cheese.
Hello, sweetie. Angela Mentor. Good to see you, dear.
Milk to my shake.
Let's see. Move Mania Nick's here. Welcome in, Nick. Diana Murphy. Good evening. Welcome in. I got John K.
The checks for my water.
Hey, y'all, Stephen K. Welcome. Good to see you. New at this. Welcome in. Howdy. And I think we might have got everybody. Let me go back down to the bottom. Jeffrey Pop, welcome. Sparkly Pink Diamonds, hello, Angie. Good evening. And Tim Rimple, what's up, buddy? Howdy, howdy. Now I think we kind of got everybody. If I missed you, I'm sorry. I couldn't get to the very top on one chat, and I was having to piece it together like a puzzle. And breaking news, we're not going to be playing Name That Movie tonight.
What?
Yep. Pam Fam, welcome in. Good to see you. I have been working. Jeff Condon, welcome. Good to see you, sir. I have Jennifer White, welcome in.
Put my hand away. Dang it.
I have been working on this all week. And I ran out of time. I just this one has taken a lot more than the music ones. So we will play name that movie next week. Purple Subi, good to see you. Welcome. Hope you're doing well.
I won't be here.
So we'll play it next week. I've got a wide variety of clips. I'm sorry, everybody. I'm sorry.
Surf Bomb, that's fine. I
was really looking forward to it. KUY, welcome. Good to see you.
You can only do so much, Chris.
I was really looking forward to it. We're going to do this one different than most of the other ones. So it's taken me a lot longer to put this one together. So there you go. But I hear there's some sales going on, or there's some stuff on some websites, so we might do some merch and shopping and whatnot tonight. And
I may have bought things.
I need to know two things though first. I need to know Donna Jaworski. Welcome in, Donna. Good to see you. Hello, hello. I hope you're doing well, Donna. I need to know Tracy and Carlos's thoughts on Miley Cyrus becoming a Disney legend.
Why only Tracy and I is the first question.
Because I feel like I've heard Joy and Tina's thoughts, maybe. If I'm wrong, y'all can share y'all's thoughts too.
No, not Joy's, because it was Angela and Molly and I last night.
That's
with
what
you.
It was. That's what it was.
And I didn't even think all of us got to say our thoughts too.
Now the question would be, why is she going into Disney Legends? If you're talking about just her segments for Hannah Montana wasn't bad, but I think I think everything she did after that kind of just like.
Why are you opening this can of worms again? Because it's a fun can.
I think she needs to grow up first before she can even become a legend.
Well, no, I mean, she's definitely grown up, but she's trying to prove that she's grown up a little bit too much.
She ain't grown up.
Yeah. So there you go. No, Justin, she is not. I don't think she'll ever become a Disney legend, so no.
But I will say that the Hannah Montana years that she was involved and it was being like the beginning made a lot of money for Disney. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah. Well, after Disney, that career took a very hard turn. So yeah.
But I think if you look at most of those teen or those, you know, child actors, as soon as they get to a certain age, they have to prove to the world that they've gone off the deep end to say that I'm not that kid anymore. You have to do that hard break. Or they think they have to do that hard break.
You know, Pete says Kelly Ripa was worse for him on the list.
Yes.
Really? Wow.
Yeah, what? Because she hosted that show. She hosted, you know, whatever, and what Regis, mm-hmm. because it's owned by ABC or CBS or whatever the hell it is.
Mm-hmm. It's owned by ABC.
I mean, come on. Yeah, it's owned by Disney, so that's not a good reason.
I'm surprised Taylor Swift didn't make the list.
Disney legends should be movies, right? Actors, directors, writers, artists, Imagineers. Not somebody who sits on a stool next to Regis, and thank God for Regis, because she wouldn't have made it halfway through if it was anybody else.
Oh, really?
And now she can't even hold a co-host that they have to bring in her husband to do it with her. So I agree with Pete. At least, yes, like Tracy said, she was Hannah Montana on the Disney Channel.
So, and she made a lot of money for him.
Yeah, I'm sure the Ripper show is bringing in money too, but
I don't think.
Let me sit here my kids
well, here's
are growing
the thing. If you look, there's.
I know, Stacy, but that doesn't mean Disney. I mean, there's all sorts of stuff on ABC. Are we going to induct every ABC star that's been on ABC for years?
Sure. Why not?
Because we're going to put in Dr. McDreamy and Dreamy and.
Well, then let's.
What you got to remember is it's not everything. Not everything on ABC is owned by ABC. Not everything on other channels are owned by their current parent group. Mm-hmm. I would say Kelly Ripa going into a legendaries is the same as saying putting Joy Behar or Whoopi Goldberg or any of those other ones from The View or whatever else that show is called. it's not real television. It's not real Icon. Hannah Montana at her height sold merch. There was kids running around trying to be like Hannah Montana, wearing Hannah Montana shirts. No one's walking around with a Kelly Ripa shirt. No one's walking around trying to be Kelly Ripa. Hannah Montana, I would say if you were putting Miley Cyrus in, you're putting her in as Hannah Montana, and that's who you should put in, not Miley Cyrus.
Yeah. Yeah, not just so Pete says the worst part was being inducted at the same time as Joe Rohde. Not only that, but John Williams, James Cameron. I mean, those two aren't even in those leagues.
So. You could have stopped right there, and that cast member that's been at Disneyland for 50 years, and
yeah,
you would have had a lot more credit than adding everybody else they added to that list. But that is, I mean, Chris, you just made a perfect point, man. It's like, you see that list, it's like, yes, Joe Rohde. Yes, Sean Williams. Kelly Ripa.
Yeah.
What?
Yeah.
Why?
I don't think he's ever left Massachusetts, so I'm excited.
But... So, there you go. Anyway, that's your Disney legend. Joy, what was your thoughts on it?
I don't really care for her. Miley Cyrus, so I agree with you guys.
Oh, I don't care for her now. Mm-hmm. I mean, I remember how my daughter used to watch Hannah Montana. You know what I mean? I know how in-depth and how intrigued she was back in the day. Nothing compared. There's nothing that holds my attention today. But I remember watching my little girl watching TV, watching Hannah Montana.
Yeah.
By the way, has anybody watched a documentary on Nickelodeon?
Oh my god.
So I started that. Yes, I did start that the other night.
All four episodes, bro. It's worth it. I told Ken's she couldn't watch it because it would destroy her. But
yeah. I didn't watch a lot of that Nickelodeon. We didn't have cable back then. And I think I was older than a lot of the demographic for that. But
if you're a kid, like the mid-2000s, you had Victorious and you had iCarly. Before that, you had all that. And you had the Amanda Bynes, the Amanda Show, Zoe 101. Ken's is more of the iCarly and Victorious era, which was about the same time that Hannah Montana was going on. So...
Yeah.
Wow.
Spaceship Pierce, welcome in. Being disappointed by the Legends list is an annual activity for me. There's usually at least one or two that you're on there that's on there that you're going, eh? I don't remember the last list being all that spectacular. I mean, there was a few on there, but Kit Stahlberg, welcome in, Kit. Good to see you. That's
I'm more than just that.
That's kind of my thoughts on it.
It's on Max. If you have Max, it's a documentary that was done by ID. Someone asked what the Nickelodeon thing was. It's worth the watch if you have Max or have ID or cable. It's worth the four episodes.
It's very interesting. There it is. Nicole put it quiet on the set, the dark side of kids TV.
That's just like a piece of what was going on in the industry. And you think of like people like Corey Feldman that came forward and how many others, and it's just Hollywood is a cesspool for disgusting stuff like that. Okay, really makes you think, makes you wonder.
Donna has another good point. I don't get Ryan Seacrest as the host either. I mean, I know American Idol, but geez, he's like the face of ABC hosting almost now with that.
Isn't he going to be like? Isn't he the new Wheel of Fortune person too?
Yes, he's going to be.
It's not me, I promise.
It's Ryan Seacrest because it's just Ryan Seacrest.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I mean, whatever he can get his hands on, or whatever any network can get Ryan Seacrest to do, then they're going to get him.
But I don't. Do they normally bring in a separate host for that Legends segment? Because I thought it was usually like Disney VIPs that did that presentation. Hello, Kat.
I'm not even. I don't know you guys. Sorry. Come on, my lap.
I'm leaving you guys.
Whatever. We'll sit there on the curb.
Mom. Sorry. Family's still here. Some of it.
Yeah.
Well, Suzanne says she's definitely not holding up her conversation for you.
Justin says this is the best Steve has ever looked. And now he's going in. So.
They're already talking about buying Halloween party tickets. Talk about something else.
I was thinking about Christmas the other day, to be honest. But it's going to be
a lot of announcements.
You know what's awesome? XM Radio has a Christmas channel all year long.
Oh, really?
Yeah, so I have it saved, and it's like, you know, when you need that little, we listen to Nat King Cole, a little D.
You know, you can just call me up. I'll sing to you.
Let me get right on.
I made a playlist the other night of some golden oldie music like that, and I was playing like Nat King Cole. And it automatically went to the next song, which was the Christmas song. Right. I was like, oh man, I miss Christmas music.
Yep.
Stacey, you would call me if you wanted some Christmas music. I had seen Christmas music.
I heard that.
Let me pull up one thing real quick here. They came out with some of the merch for May the 4th, since we're talking about holidays. I guess that's the next big, well, there's Easter, of course, but they've already released a lot of the Easter merch. They've come out with some of the merch for May the 4th, including a new Darth Maul Legacy hilt.
That's cool.
In a case. It's limited to 7,000, and it'll be available on Shop Disney for approximately 1.5 minutes, and at Walt Disney World and Disneyland Resorts on May the 4th. Not listed price, but I would assume this will probably be $400 or $450. Then you got, there's your hat for the day. There are Phantom Menace 25th anniversary hoodies, zip hoodies. There are pins or plates or something. What did I miss?
No, it's not in chat. She messaged me. Sorry, that got me.
Yeah. All sorts of stuff coming out for May the 4th. The hat is cool. I do like the hat.
Yeah, I would take the hat. I'm not spending money on no lightsaber hilt, I'll tell you, that's for sure.
I would love to have that hilt. I've always wanted to buy two of the Darth Maul hilts and put them together to make the staff. But yeah,
I'm not doing it.
I can't do that much. No. yeah. Sebastian the Crab, Jeanette. Hello. Welcome in. Good to see you, Jeanette. Two N's, one Y. But it's not where you think. Tim Rimple says he needs the saber. Is Justin going to need the lightsaber?
I don't know, but I think I need it because he's my favorite bad guy.
I love that Darth Maul hilt. That, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. They also released on Shop Disney the, I think the Ahsoka ones are back in stock on Shop Disney now. And then you get the two hilts with that one. And somebody said the Asajj Ventress was coming back, which is also two hilts that connect, but I haven't seen it on Shop Disney. So, limited time thing. Joy can get me one and think it's hers. Jonathan Chong, welcome in. Good to see you. Tina said there was some new stuff on Shop Disney, or stuff restocked on Shop Disney.
Yeah, the lamp is back, the water tower lamp.
Nice.
I don't know what else, though. That was the only thing that was in my wish list, and I just went to go take a peek because one Jennifer Caruso was shopping at the warehouse, and I got bit by the shopping bug. And when I went and looked at my wish list, it was there, and I was like, so I snagged it. I'm so excited.
It had been gone for a while. I'm surprised it came back, to be honest, with them moving past that whole Eras collection and everything. Good night, Nick.
Good night, Nick.
That kind of surprises me that it came back.
Did you realize I'm muted? it was back in the park a couple of weeks ago, too.
Was it?
There. Yeah. Okay. Which was shocking as well. But it wasn't on sale like everything else was. Because everything else from that collection was like 50% off.
Really?
Yeah.
All the Eras stuff.
Yeah.
Interesting. Yeah, I did not expect it to come back. I guess it's probably been on order and they're just now getting it in, why it's back, but that's cool. There is some new stuff on Shop Disney that I haven't seen before. Well, I think it's interesting anyway. This is a new Walt Disney World Mickey Mouse ball cap. So you got the M and Mickey there on the front and Walt Disney World written on the back or side. That one's $20.99. This is a Roosevelt, if these stupid things will go away. You got the Roosevelt logo on the side and then Disney Mickey and Friends on the back. That one's $35. It's Roosevelt's. This is Donald Duck having a fit with the signature.
I like that one.
Then you got just the solo Mickey in black and red. And he got his little hand over here making a peace sign. And then this is the new Bluey family action figure set for $15.99.
Jeff's already got it.
I wouldn't be surprised.
Jeff's probably playing with them right now.
You can make them sit down or stand up and their arms move. Jeanette says, I wish you could pull off hats. They look dumb on me, but there are many cute ones. Yeah. I want more Nike Legacy Disney hats. Those are my favorites. I haven't tried one of those.
I know, Jeanette. He's playing with his Bluey set right now.
Yep. I love a lot of the Disney hats. I'm kind of picky. I like a fitted hat, and they don't do fitted hats much anymore.
But yeah, that's what
it is. Chris, I'm going to step off a minute. I'll be back in a little while.
All good.
All right. I'll be back in a little bit. Yep.
Carlos has got some family over, so no worries. I have bought when I was on a trip recently, I went to, as I talked about the National Air and Space Museum, and I bought a couple of hats there that were not fitted, and I've really kind of liked those, so maybe I'll try one of these, but for some reason I prefer fitted ones. So anyway,
I like the fitted ones, but my head is too big.
Oh, surely not, Joey.
It is. It's pretty big. I usually only fit into the trucker hats.
There's some new makeup on Shop Disney by Sigma Beauty. We got Beauty and the Beast mini eyeshadow palette, a mini lip set, which I assume is like lip gloss or lipstick, and then a cheek palette. So there you go. There's also a brush set. Oh, she looks very stylish with her brush set. Look what these brushes can do for you.
What is she wearing?
That's a lot of makeup.
Yeah.
That blue does not go with that white lace. Oh.
Oh, you were talking about the whole outfit.
Yeah.
Yeah. It's like over the lace.
Mm-hmm.
It is over the lace.
Sorry. I like the brushes.
$89 for the brush set with a pouch. It says Beauty and the Beast. I assume Sigma is like a nice fashion, or is that cleavage? No, it's not. No, it's lace, apparently. So there you go.
Yeah, Mara, I get that too.
There's the
the
orange bird planter. I think that's cute.
That is cute.
Oh, I also think back in the day, I would have used that for an ice cream bowl. So the sets are manufactured differently. Okay. Interesting. Sigma has good brushes only if you buy them individually.
I know nothing. I can put the laundry over. I'll be right back.
What, Tina?
I gotta go swap
the laundry. Doing laundry.
Okay. Tina's doing laundry. Carlos has got family. Joy's here. And Tracy's here. Chilling. We've got the orange bird ornament. That one's cute. And then the orange bird, I assume this is a vase. I don't know what they call it, a ceramic pitcher. But I don't know what you'd put in that.
Orange juice. It's going
to be hard to pour it out.
I was about to say it'd be hard to pour it out, and it doesn't close. So.
Right.
Yeah.
$24.99.
I'm assuming it's decorative.
Yeah.
Inspired by the two-sided. Hand wash only, not microwave or dishwasher safe. Wash thoroughly before use. Holds 18 ounces. So they act like they want you to use it as a pitcher, but that just seems like a weird pitcher to me.
Well, see, here's the thing. They know that no one's going to put any liquid in there.
Mm-hmm.
They're selling it as a decorative piece. So.
I guess, yeah.
They're just throwing that in there just to say, hey, if you are stupid enough to use this as holding liquid.
If they had a sugar bowl with it, maybe. Yeah, Jeanette, true. Stacy said that I may not be able to use the orange bird pot as an ice cream bowl. Some flower pots have a hole in it. That's true, Stacy. But Jeff was in the park the other day and found that, and there is no hole in the bottom of that one. So, that's why I said that. Justin says orange juice is better than apple juice, and I completely agree with that comment.
Oh.
Now, apple cider is better than Orange Juice.
No.
Yes.
No.
Correct me. Speaking from the New York, the great state of New York, apples in New York are the thing.
Yep. And the cider is to die for. It's not like anywhere else. I'll give them that.
Okay. There are some new, Jim Shore, figures. This is the Tigger. It's $59.99. He's floating like a butterfly and stinging like a bee. Bee boxing. You've got Piglet picked for you. I was wondering what that word said. I had to look closely. Piglet in a flower watering can. $39.99. You got Chippendale Mischievous Bunnies with an Easter egg there for $74.99. And then you got Pooh, Piglet, and Eeyore here together, friends forever, $89.99. And then here is Mickey and Minnie with their Easter basket, Springtime Sweetheart, $74.99.
Those are cute.
Those are cute. I don't understand these pins with the fake succulent sticking out of them, but there you go. These are the new Princess pins, and I don't like these.
Mm-mm, not either.
The past ones were much better. They actually were more like the crowns. Like they had the little holes that the crowns would have going through them. They're not solid pieces like these. So yeah, got a group pop socket. This is back. So this is in with that stuff that the water lamp. And I looked at getting one of these. This is the Disney Studios street sign, but it's $80. And that,
yeah.
Did you see that when you were down there?
I did not.
I thought it was cheesy. It's really? Not. Yeah. I don't think that's metal. I think it's all plastic.
Resin, stone powder. It doesn't say what the arms are.
The arms are plastic, if I'm not mistaken. If I can remember right, when we were down there, I seen that. It's plastic. So
I like the water tower better, and the water tower is about the same price. $79.99 for that.
I don't think it's worth $79. Maybe you find it in the outlet store. You pick it up for $20.
Yeah. Yeah. This is the Orange Bird Solar Lantern. It you turn it on and it glows, and yeah.
That's cute.
$24.99 for it. This is the Mickey Mouse wood desk lamp from the home collection, $39.99. I have not seen that. I like that.
Mm-hmm.
That's kind of cool. Yeah. There's the Stitch light we were talking about last night on Peach Stream. That was $29.99 at Animal Kingdom. Right now it's on sale for $20. I'm still not sure I'd pay $20 for that.
It's cute.
He looks kind of weird lit up. That is 8 1/4 inches long. I was wondering how long it was. There you go. You could probably make those with a 3D printer. Oh, the street sign, probably. Yeah. So, is orange chocolate an actual thing? I've heard of it, but like a myth, I've never seen it in real life. I have had orange chocolate and I love it. It's really good. I usually find it for some reason at Christmas a lot. They sell it in like a little ball that looks like an orange, and you're supposed to like hit it on the table oranges. And it breaks apart in orange slices, but it's
all, it doesn't taste like oranges.
It's orange flavored, yes. Yeah. See, Katie, why? Yeah. Dark chocolate with orange flavor is good. Yeah. I haven't had chocolate.
I might have had that when I was younger, but.
You can find orange chocolate sticks at Cracker Barrel. Really? I guess that's another reason to go to Cracker Barrel.
It's been a long week, bro.
Huh?
It's been a long week.
It has been a long week. Yep. So let's see. There are some new pens on Shop Disney as well. Joey, have you been buying any pens lately?
No, I haven't.
I haven't bought pens in a long time.
She's buying lightsaber hilts.
I wish I could, but I haven't bought those either. This is the Darling Family and Nana Best Dog Parent. I don't know. There you go. It's a spinner. This is the Kermit the Frog Find a Rainbow Day 2024 pin. I never knew there was a Find a Rainbow Day, but there you go. There's a pin for it. This is the Duchess and Kitten's Best Cat Parent pen. I know somebody that could use that pen. Cracker Barrel. Justin says IHOP is better than Cracker Barrel. Come, oh, now, Justin. Yeah.
I don't think so.
This was news yesterday too. Yeah. The cast members, pin lanyards are coming back. So cast members are going to start wearing the little pouch again so that you can pin trade with them throughout the parks. Now I was glad to see that back. Justin, I'm sticking with Cracker Barrel over the IHOP.
I'm sticking with Cracker Barrel.
Yeah. This is the Disney Dogs Mystery Pin Set. Two pins in a pack. And $19.99 per box. Here is your Easter pin for Shop Disney or Disney Store, whatever they're calling it this month. And then you got Mickey Mouse Clubhouse pin, mystery pack, five pins in a box per pack. $39.99. Jeez, these prices going up. This is the Sword series, the Tales of the Sword. We were talking about those the other night. Those are available on Shop Disney now. All sorts of pins. Haven't bought pins in a long time. Here's the other princess pins. I just don't like these like the past ones.
Yeah,
previous ones were much prettier.
I kind of like the Easter pin, but that's about the only one I like.
Yeah. This is an odd looking Snow White. Celebrate World Wildlife Day.
Her eyes are like really big.
That is very odd looking to me. Coco seems, or Miguel seems to have some weird eyes going on as well. What is it with you people and eyes on pins? Looks like he also has two different mouths. Yeah. So there you go.
What are you eating, Tina?
Dried mango.
Dried mango. You dry it yourself or do you buy it dried?
I buy it dried.
Do you suck on it to rehydrate it?
No, I'm doing that with other things.
Okay. I didn't know if you just like bit off of it or if you. Okay.
Just bite it.
It's never good to bite them.
Yeah. So, yeah. Hey, I'm just asking questions. I'm trying to learn. I've never had dried mango.
I just made a statement. And next thing you know, I lost her.
Diz Noah loves dried mangoes. I didn't know these were a thing.
It's like ice cream cones. You don't bite into an ice cream cones. You got to lick them.
See, this is the question I was having. Is it chewy or crunchy? I mean, do you chew on it or is it crunchy like a dried apricots or what?
Is it like a dried banana or is it like beef jerky?
She's muted and she's talking to us, but we don't hear a single word.
No, it's soft and it's flexible.
Oh, okay.
It's pliable. Some pieces are a little bit more softer than others. This one's kind of like a tough piece, so I'm going to ditch it. Not all of them are like that, and not it's just my preference.
Disney Baker. Chris, good evening, sir. Good to see you. Good to see you. Mangoes fresh off the tree are the way to go, says Zen Light.
I love mangoes. Mangoes my favorite fruit. Dried adult fruit strips. Yes, exactly.
Good night, Corby. Have a good night and a good Sunday.
Hi, Pence.
Kenzie. I
also love mango. It is so good. I recently just bought, so I got a mango at the store a little while ago, but I didn't realize the ripening process of a mango because I've never really bought it before. So I left it in my fridge and it took like 2 weeks till it was like in any kind of state for me to cut it up and it still wasn't ready.
So. I like juices mixed with mango. So like orange mango or different stuff like that. But I've never eaten just straight mango before.
It's like a nice snack. I used it, I was doing teaching observations and stuff. And I brought some mango in with me as a little snack during my day of teaching, and it's a good snack. I've been trying to have more fruits like that more.
We get dragon fruits at the Asian store. So I got a dragon fruit protein drink the other day, and it was pretty good. I've never had dragon fruit before.
Dragon fruit has, I feel like, does anybody else have dragon fruit? It has no flavor.
Really?
I have an issue with the seeds. Too many seeds.
There's a lot of seeds.
I don't like anything with seeds. That's why I like mango so much, is because you don't have to worry about like little seeds. That's why I don't like strawberries.
Mm-hmm.
I love dried fruit. I just wish they wouldn't add the sugar. You know? I really don't know how to pick out fresh mango, but dehydrated mango is good, says Nicole.
Dad wants to change the name.
Oh, okay. Yeah. I can't do a whole lot of fresh fruit right yet, so yeah. Here in Florida, the mango trees everywhere, walk up, pick and eat, says it's nice.
I would love that.
Hey, Chris.
Yep.
I'm beat. I've been up early.
Yep.
I made a brisket today, so I'm going to have Ken's take over.
That took up a lot of his energy.
Have a good night, Tracy.
All right, guys. Thank you for letting me on. I'll see you next week for Name That Movie. And she's home this weekend, so
I've hijacked his spot, if that's okay.
Okay.
I know you're a brother. So it's gonna be Chris and the girls tonight.
Yeah.
Until never mind. Then it'll still be Chris and the girls.
Yeah, when Carlos goes back, it's still Chris and the girls.
Well, I meant Steve, but Carlos too.
Remember, Justin says, remember when they said all the food in the future would be dehydrated? Yeah, it's like two little capsules that you drop in a bowl, and then you put it in the microwave, and then you open up the microwave, and it's like this huge turkey with all the fixings. meet George Jetson. Mike Wheeler said, yeah, mangoes aren't supposed to be refrigerated before ripen. You ripen them like a banana, put them in a bag, and they sweeten and soften.
I had no idea.
Interesting.
I felt very stupid when I found out, because every day I took the mango out and I was like, is it ready yet? And it was never ready. Then I looked it up and I was like, oh, okay. I just like, I'm not supposed to do that.
Astronaut food, says Detroit Diz. Yeah. Listen, astronaut food. So I thought when I went to the museum with Snickerdoodle, I thought, you know what? I'm going to buy a bunch of different packs of astronaut ice cream and try them, because I've never tried it before. And I remember as a kid going to Kennedy Space Center and wanting to get them and never did. So I thought, I'm going to get two or three different flavors and we'll try them on stream. Those things were like $12 a bag, and it felt like you were buying just a piece of styrofoam. I'm like, I'm not paying $12. For a small little piece of styrofoam. No, that's crazy. So sorry, y'all missed out on me trying astronaut ice cream.
Justin bought us chicken nuggets in a tube for Christmas, and I'm not trying that. I think that's what they take to space, but I'm not trying it.
Chicken nuggets in a tube.
Is it like liquid nuggets?
Yeah. Yeah.
Nice. welcome back.
Thank you very much.
Hi, Carlos.
Wow, Tracy, you have gotten light in color. I know. A little less hair. You are looking a lot sexier right now than you did. Oh, Kenzie. Hi, Kenzie.
I'm home for the weekend, so.
Oh, that's nice.
I was supposed to be playing the pit for my old high school's show, but we got major snow, so they canceled tonight's show.
Yeah, I heard you guys.
How much did you guys end up getting?
Quite a bit. It was enough that the roads were pretty bad.
Yeah.
And they had to cancel the show. But, you know, at least they have two other shows. Mm-hmm. They had last night's and they've got tomorrow's, you know. They've got one.
I wanted to let me pull something up real quick here. Get this site to work for me.
Yeah, Jeanette, but you know, I'm happy that they got the show last night, and then they'll have the show tomorrow. I'm glad that they at least get two of their three performances. Dad was like, you shouldn't feel bad for them. You know, you didn't even get your entire show. And I was like, you know, I don't want to spread that negativity. I want to, you know, I'm glad that they got at least two of their shows.
That's a bonus.
All right, let me do it this way. Let's go here. I swear we're going to get there. Sorry for the wait, y'all.
I'm just going to go shopping. Because I haven't spent enough.
Carlos, do you have the basketball game on?
Which one? I don't. I just sat down. I'm looking for one. I know NC State won.
They did. They did. I was watching that one. There it is. That's what I was looking for. Let me go here. And buddy.
What up?
Welcome in.
Yeah.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, everybody.
Hi, Steve.
Hi, Steve.
What are we doing?
Well, we were going to do name that movie tonight, but I ran out of time, so we're going to have to push it to next week.
Hi, Justin.
Oh. Fake snickerdoodle finally made it. Yep.
Oh, Angela's here too?
Yep.
Sweet.
Oh, what channel is that game on?
So, Joy, you were talking about chicken nuggets in a tube.
Mm-hmm. No, that made me think.
That made me think. I had a grilled chicken tender today, and I bought some Sweet Baby Ray's no sugar added barbecue sauce.
The sweet and smoky one and the sweet and spicy one are my favorites.
I got the sweet and smoky one, and it was amazing.
Yeah.
I've never tried the no sugar added one, and it was really good.
Oh, all those are no sugar added?
These are all no sugar added versions.
Interesting.
We buy a lot of this, but not no sugar added. Haven't tried any of those.
I was really surprised how good it was. It was really good.
Can I be a killjoy?
Yes.
I don't like Sweet Baby Ray's.
Really?
Why not?
One
of my friends who lives in Rehoboth was like, you gotta try Sweet Baby Ray's. And so I tried it one day. We were having burgers and I tried it. Or steak or something.
Which and one I was did like, try?
Well, that's your first problem. You don't put crap on steak. So it's
that is number one.
Like, yeah, I don't remember what it was. Whatever it is that you put barbecue sauce, I don't remember what we were eating.
Whatever it is you put barbecue sauce.
It didn't wow me like another. I don't know. Maybe I'm just so used to honey barbecue.
What flavor was it?
It was just the regular kind, I think.
Yeah, the regular one's not the best.
I like the Hawaiian one.
That's good too.
Yeah.
Or maybe it was. You know what? I'm just gonna go on a Sweet Baby Ray's tangent and go buy them all and try them all.
So we usually get the original barbecue, and I got burnt out on that, Tina. I'll be honest, I don't like it anymore.
Okay.
But I got a thing of the sweet and smoky to try it, and I really like it. It's got a good flavor. It worked for me.
Oh, and do you see? Hold on, let me see. I have it in my fridge. Hold on.
If you like Sweet Heat, which is one of my favorite sauces, no matter where I go for like chicken wings and all that, that sweet and spicy is really good.
Is it? So, I'm afraid to do spicy right now, Steve.
Yeah.
Is it spicy? Should I hold off on that one?
It's got a kick.
Okay. That's why I kind of went with sweet and smoky that I got. Bullseye Barbecue says in likes. I've tried Bullseye. That's good too.
Kylo, get lost. Is Sweet Golden Mustard on that list?
No, they just have the honey mustard.
All right, yeah, because I was gonna try to explain a sauce that we have up here in New England. It's called Gold Fever, and Sweet Baby Ray's has the Sweet Golden Mustard, and that's pretty much what it is.
Yeah. Let's see if it'll go here.
Does that say fruit? Oh, full lineup. I thought this was a fruit lineup. I was like, fruit.
There's the Hawaiian. Here's the sweet golden mustard. It's pretty good.
They have like a whole line. Holy cow. Yeah.
There's tons of them.
Oh my gosh.
Now these aren't the sugar free ones. These are just the regular.
I just bought the buffalo one today. It was on sale. 2 for $4.
Is that lemon pepper? What's the third one there?
Garlic parmesan.
Oh, I've never had that one.
Carlos, was it at Stop and Shop?
It was.
I knew it. I missed Stop
and Shop. What is Stop and Shop?
It's New England area grocery store.
They have another pasta in the country, but it's a different name. Shoot, I can't remember what it's called now.
They've got sauce for everything.
Yeah, we get the sweet and smoky at our apartment. I'm a, as I would call, a recovering picky eater, so it's the only kind of barbecue sauce I'll have is the sweet and smoky. That's kind of my favorite. But there was another one that we've been getting that I'm just... Matt makes ribs every Sunday. Like, that's kind of like a thing at our apartment, is like Matt makes ribs every Sunday. And we've been trying out a lot of different kinds of barbecue sauces. And that's one that I've actually liked.
Welcome in, Adventures with VP. Good to see you, bud. Hey. Hope you're doing well.
Oh, and maybe it's
Cardillo. Welcome in, Joseph.
I think maybe it's more Northeast then, because it's not just New England, because Stacy has one too. So I stand corrected. I'll be right back.
Detroit Diz says, does anyone have a Wingstop near them? I don't. Unless that's the one that, is that the one that like Pizza Hut does as well as that Wingstop? I can't remember.
Wingstop's really good. We have one at Foxwoods that I tried to hit on the way out.
I've never done Wingstop.
They're winning by two.
What, 3 seconds?
There's another one here that I was wanting to mention. And I don't see it here. Don't see it there. Interesting. I may have to go buy more of this. So there's another brand that I recently tried. G Hughes Sugar Free. They do all sorts of barbecue sauces as well. Dipping sauces. They've got a Polynesian sauce, a yum yum sauce, steak sauces, all sorts of different stuff. At my grocery store, they even do dressings. At my grocery store, they had a sweet and sour sauce, and I tried it, and it's amazing. Really good. So if anybody's interested, I'm just learning all sorts of stuff. I like to go to the grocery store now and explore and try to find different things.
I love doing that.
I found turkey hot dogs. I'm going to try those at some point.
Is that like all turkey meat?
Yeah.
Or like every part of the turkey?
I think it said what part of the turkey it was. I can't remember if it's all white meat or what, but Zippity Doo Dug, welcome man. Good to see you. I'm enjoying my turkey sausage.
I like turkey.
That's been good.
Mm-hmm.
Tennessee pulled it off. Damn it.
Did they?
Yeah. They would tie for a couple of seconds. Sorry, I'm trying to move you. So I can open or recline.
What was I going for? Tennessee. That's what I was going for. Because they were going against Texas, right?
So Mar said something about how do you become a recovering picky eater? I'm a true picky eater. So I was like a hardcore picky eater for the first, 18 years of my life. And I kind of, once I graduated high school, I was like, I'm just so over being picky, and I was so frustrated with it, and I started slowly introducing myself to new things, and I'm still doing it very slowly to this day, but I've made really big strides in all of that. I like ranch now. I tried ranch for the first time a few months ago, and I like that, so that's like
a... Good night, Tim Ripple. Welcome to the Ranch Club. Good night, Tim. Good. Have a good one. Justin said something. Team Joy, is he being serious? I like turkey pepperoni over regular.
Yeah. I buy him the turkey pepperoni. I don't like the way it tastes though, so I buy the regular kind for me, but he likes turkey. We also have turkey burgers too.
It's not bad.
You too.
I've been craving pepperoni, but I can't have pepperoni. So really.
Yeah, turkey pepperoni is really good. It's even
it's
I like it better than regular too.
It definitely tastes different though than regular pepperoni.
I won't push it to liking it better than a regular pepperoni, but it's not bad.
Not bad. Okay.
Have we had it? Yeah, I bought it accidentally once.
You said turkey burgers. Mm-hmm. I've had those before. Those I hadn't had tried those yet since everything. But I used to like those some. We usually will get two salmon burgers. So we'll get like the salmon that's in the shape of a burger. That's really good.
Cool.
I like those, or used to like those anyway.
You grill it or fry it?
Usually grill it.
Usually grill it?
Yeah.
I've seen them in my local grocery store and I'm like, I don't know. I can't see me eating those.
I really liked them. We would get them with, I don't know. Y'all have Pepperidge Farm breads, I guess. Yeah. Pepperidge Farm does a flat bun that's supposed to be like less carbs. They're really good on those flat buns. I like mine with like some provolone.
I don't like mustard. Flat. I like good puffy round buns.
Yeah.
Yeah. Nothing. Not a thing. Huh? All right. That's fine.
Chicken burgers from Costco are really good, says Justin. They were, I saw those the other day at Costco. I was wondering if they were good or if they had any flavor to them. Let's see.
Does that mean you're going to start eating like Impossible Burgers instead of like real beef burgers?
Listen, so here's the deal. I looked at Impossible
Burgers. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to get it.
I looked at Impossible Burgers the other day. I can't do those.
Yeah,
it's just not. I just don't.
I had one accidentally at Starlight Cafe.
Yeah.
During the Christmas party, what was it? 2 years ago, whatever the hell it was. I gagged every time I took a bite.
I just don't. I literally did.
I'm like, I'm not getting in line. We're at the Christmas party. I want to hurry up and get out there. I'm not getting back in line. And it was like every time I took a bite, I'm like, well, hurry up and swallow it.
What about a soy burger or a bean burger? I can't do soy. I'm allergic to soy. So, yeah.
Justin is too.
I am. I have to be careful with all those protein drinks I was drinking. I had to be careful to make sure they were soy free, which is harder than you think to find sometimes. But yeah, I looked at those, Carlos, and I was like, I can't do that. That's when I started looking at the turkey burgers instead. Zanlax mentioned bison burgers. I've had a bison burger one time, and that was good.
That's very good.
Yeah. So,
They're a little rougher. A little, what's the word I'm looking for? Oh, a little drier.
Yeah.
Meat. Yeah.
I have a confession.
Another one?
This whole time.
The third one of the night.
This whole time, I didn't know what the Impossible Whopper was at Burger King. I thought it meant that they just put everything on it and it made it impossible to eat. I didn't know that.
Yeah, welcome in, Tina.
Yeah. Welcome to the year 2024, Tina. Good job. I haven't had a good Whopper in a while. Susan, I think we're having Burger King. Oh, shoot. We have leftovers from tonight.
I had eggplant tonight. It was really good.
I don't mind eggplant when it's with something else.
What does it taste like?
Like, I don't get people eating eggplant Parmesan.
What does it taste like?
That's what we had.
Yeah, see, I don't mind eggplant as a side, as the veggie, because that's what it is. But I can't just, like, I don't know, just knowing it's like, all right, I mean, eggplant and cheese. Thank you.
Carlos, when you eat as little as I do, everything you're eating is just a side.
Well. Touche, my friend. Touche.
I had mom this morning fix me an egg and one of my turkey sausage patties. I made it through maybe half of the egg and about half of the sausage, and I was done.
Wow, that's insane. I told you last week, man. I don't get it how that works, but good for you. Good for you, and everybody else has gone through it, but just me thinking of it, it's like, wow. You know? Like, I picture, like, how much I ate tonight, and then listening to what you're saying, it's like, I can't imagine, like, having a quarter of a slice of pizza and be like, I'm done.
Yeah. Good night, Baker. Have a good one.
Night.
See you. Mar says, I've never tasted it. It's good. Stacy likes eggplant Parmesan fried egg. I haven't tried it fried, but it, you know.
She keeps asking me, what does it taste like? Like a vegetable. I mean, I don't know how to explain it. I mean,
it makes a great lasagna. You can do a great lasagna.
Yeah.
Spaceship Ears said, when Windows 7 was released, Burger King in Japan had a special Whopper with 7 patties because Japan, of course. That would have been an impossible burger.
Grandmother used to make eggplant Parmesan, and I would always eat it, and then my mouth would do, like, funny things, and I would, like, snatch some of the eggplant before it went into the Parmesan. And at one point, it made me itchy. And so I'm allergic to eggplant. I don't know how I keep, I don't know, whatever. It's just frustrating.
But that's the boy child. He's allergic to the weirdest thing. He's allergic to salmon. I've never met anyone that's allergic to it. The only fish he's allergic to is salmon.
Well, it's the mercury in it.
Mercury in it, I guess.
It is. Is it my mother-in-law? Is it your mother? Or your father that's allergic to it, too?
No, my mom doesn't like it. My dad doesn't like it. My mom likes it. Then nobody's allergic.
I thought one of them was allergic. Okay.
I've got that same issue with shellfish. I got a test done, and they were like, oh, by the way, you're allergic to shrimp. And I was like, well, that's why my mouth hurts when I eat it. And then I didn't have any allergic reactions to any other shellfish. Last year, we went to Cape Cod, and I had scallops, and I was perfectly fine. And then 2 months ago, I got, like, mini scallops or whatever for us to have for dinner, and I had an allergic reaction to it. So I'm, like, slowly developing more and more shellfish allergies. And if I ever have an allergic reaction to crab legs, I will probably cry for, like, 3 days straight. It's like my favorite food ever, but it's just like slowly increasing. So I always try and avoid any kind of shellfish other than crab legs, because I just like shellfish is one of those things that is like that can get really bad really fast. So I try and avoid that. Like when I was in Cape Cod, I would ask if the stuff that I was getting had been fried with the shrimp and stuff. And if it had, I tried to avoid that.
I'll tell you another thing I saw, Carlos, along the lines of the Impossible Burgers at the grocery store, but I just couldn't bring myself to get over next to the frozen fry section where they have like the Arby's curly fries that look so good and the Checkers fries and all. We have a section of veggie fries and veggie onion rings. And I'm like, no, that's not a French fry. I'm not even going to try. No.
Wait, veggie onion rings? And it's an onion. It's a vegetable.
Exactly. That's what I thought too. I did not know that, Snickerdoodle. That's what I saw, veggie onion rings, and I was like, why? I mean,
that's crazy.
That made no sense to me. But cauliflower instead of mashed potatoes, I tried that one time at somebody's house. I can't do that. That is not mashed potatoes. Don't even try to pretend like they're mashed potatoes. So anyway, weird things you find. Technically, a potato is a tuber.
What about cauliflower pizza crust?
It's
shocking. It's shocking that they can't hear you when I don't have my headphones on. So I'm gonna put my headphones on so you can ask your own questions.
I heard her say something, but I didn't hear exactly what she said.
She was asking about cauliflower pizza crust.
So I've tried that before when we were working in the office. You could get, they had a pizza station where they would make pizza fresh for you. And they had the option of cauliflower crust. And I tried it one time. It wasn't bad. I haven't tried one yet, to be honest. I had a chicken soft taco for supper last night on my zero carb tortilla that was about that big around.
Was it good?
It was good. Yeah. I think they're by the same like Mission or whatever brand it is that makes all sorts of tortillas at the grocery store, but they were good. Let's see. Somebody asked, fries. Oh, who else dips their fries in ranch? I used to do that all the time. Stephen K. I did find sugar-free Heinz ketchup, and that's pretty good.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Cool.
A few years back, Oreos made cookies and cream Oreos. Oreos are cookies. That's true. Yeah, they only sell it in, like, the tiny bottle, but it's good. So, or at least my grocery store only had it in the tiny bottle. Dustin says, I want to work in an office where they make me pizzas. Yeah, I miss those days. They had a full grill and everything. Those were fun. So, Blaze has different pizza crusts, says Amy AJC. I haven't been to Blaze. Well, I've never been to the Blaze at Disney Springs. And I think there's one near me, but I've never been to it.
We have one here in Rhode Island I've never been to.
Yeah.
I think we've been once. I think I liked it, and I'm really picky about my pizza and stuff, but I liked it.
I know Steve goes to it a good bit and likes it.
Oh, we got, yeah, the kids go to the one in Disney Springs all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, Peyton loves that one.
I like these.
I remember back in the day, I guess this was back when it was still downtown Disney or whatever, but Wolfgang Puck's used to have a pizza place over there.
Yeah.
That was good pizza. Hey, Amy, welcome in. Yeah. I liked it. I think there's still a Wolfgang Puck restaurant over there, and they may still do some pizzas, but it's not like it, not the same.
Yeah, he still has his regular restaurant. He closed the quick service.
Yeah. I wish I could get a Pilat pig near me. That would be nice.
Are they a chain?
No, I don't think so.
Okay.
No, I'll. They're not a chain, but I think he owns like 5 restaurants.
Okay.
They're just different names, but they own a few.
Stephanie L says there's a pizza place in downtown Orlando that I never hear anyone talk about, but pics look amazing. It's something underground pizza. Did you see the news about Raglan Road the other day, Carlos?
Which?
So apparently they've had to add a disclaimer on their menu, something about that their kitchen does serve like fishes and other products with nuts in them. Someone passed away
because of the doctor that died.
Yeah.
Which some people still believe is the husband had something to do with it, but
me. Yeah.
Because it was just weird how her allergy did not hit until, I'm sorry, I don't personally know people with peanut allergies, but what I have read and what I have seen, that crap hits you really quick.
mine has always
hit me pretty quick. The time frame does not add up to to when she ate to when she died.
Yeah.
It just doesn't, I don't know, to me it just doesn't make any sense. But, you know.
Yeah.
So, yeah, Dad, I knew about the death. I didn't know about the disclaimer. I'm still aggravated that somebody posted a picture again of the sandwich and it's back to the small size again.
Really?
Yeah.
God, that was such a good sandwich.
Yeah, to me, it's still the best sandwich on property, but
it was really good.
That small.
I was disappointed to hear that Regal Eagle has kind of fallen and not as good as what it was.
Yeah, that's what I've heard. Yeah.
Jeff and I think Wendy B said Tony and a bunch of them went the other week. And we're really disappointed in it.
So. Yeah, I guess Zach didn't like it either recently.
Yeah. Carlos just gave it a thumbs down. There you go. What?
Did I?
Yeah.
Well, I just scratched my ear. Jesus. Thumbs down with a scratched ear.
Emily, LSU mom, welcome in. Says, yes, from what I know, food allergies usually hit you right away. Mine always have.
Mine too.
When I found out I was allergic to soy, I took a sip of a drink with soy in it, and it hit me pretty quick. I mean, and usually if something's cooked in peanut oil, if I don't know beforehand, I can tell you pretty quickly.
Well, she had time to go shopping with her mommy before she died. Mother-in-law.
And he went back to the hotel.
Yeah.
And then the mother-in-law left her.
Steve Browning wants to know what sandwich is the best sandwich on property from Raglan.
It's worth the wait. Seriously, that's the name of the sandwich. I'm not trying to be an ass or anything. It's worth the wait.
Janice said she was disappointed in Regal Eagle in January. That's sad because that was really good.
We usually only go there as if it's like we really just need to get somewhere. Like we really just need to eat some food, especially when Matt and I do the, we were doing the sharing the drinking around the world thing where we would like share the drinks and stuff. You got to get some food in you when you're doing that. And usually that's where we'll stop for something, but I don't think we went the last trip.
I didn't eat there the last trip. I really wanted to, but I didn't make it over there. But I know when Woody's opened up a year ago, which just made its 1-year anniversary. When Woody's opened up a year ago, some people were saying that Regal Eagle was almost just as good as Woody's.
I really liked Woody's. I thought that was really great. Well, we had a great experience going there.
I haven't been since it was a burger place, and I was always like, in Epcot, you have so many choices, and you're getting a burger. Yeah. That's kind of true now with all the different booths everywhere and everything. There's food everywhere at Epcot.
Joy, where are you eating at Epcot? I gotta get going.
Oh.
Sorry for taking over on Dad's part.
All good. Have a good night, Kenzie. Good to see you.
All
right.
Bye.
See
you. My brain.
Where do you eat in Epcot, Joy?
I like the barbecue place, but now I'm worried that it's gonna not gonna like it anymore.
Joyce deleted the electric umbrella was the best.
I did eat there when they had it, and I was sad that it was gone. But I do like the barbecue. I liked it last year when I got it, but now I'm worried it's not gonna be good anymore.
Let me see. I want to see if they have. Angela says I'm concerned too, but do like connect. I like connections. That's where I was just pulling up the menu for. Connections got a good chicken sandwich.
Hey, Chris, can you not eat Chick-fil-A?
So, their fries don't do well for me, but I can eat the Chick-fil-A sandwiches. I don't know what it is.
They talk about now or in general?
In general.
Really? Oh, I love their fries. My God.
I did not like their fries. Their fries would sometimes make my throat hurt. But
really?
Yeah, they use peanut oil usually. Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Well, yeah.
All right. But
I'll go to get salad, and I have to get like a large fry to go with it.
Yeah.
Because I love their fries.
Grilled Chick-fil-A is surprisingly good, says Spaceship Pierce, and that's what I eat now. Is I will get the grilled chicken nuggets, and eat about two or three of them.
Well, don't get this. Well, you can't eat salad yet, but I was going to say, don't get their salads because they're just too big for you.
That before the surgery, I had their wrap. I really liked their wraps.
Mm.
They had a grilled chicken wrap that was really good.
What else?
I've never tried their salads, though. I like Zaxby's salads.
But I tend to get the most at Chick-fil-A. I'm sorry. I might be biased. I'm not biased. I might be in the... what's the word I'm looking for? Yeah, I'm not a big fan of their sandwiches. I already have Popeyes.
Yeah.
Minority. I was looking for the word minority. I might be in a minority here, but I already have a Popeyes sandwich or even a Kentucky Fried Chicken sandwich over a Chick-fil-A one. But I do love their salads. They make a really good Cobb salad.
That's the eatery. That's what I meant to do. Here. I love Arby's chicken sandwich, says Spaceship Ears. I've never tried chicken at Arby's.
It's good.
Tina doesn't like Arby's.
Oh, I love
Arby's. I hate Arby's with a passion. Although I haven't tried their chicken. So
Arby's is so good.
Roast and Swiss.
Pan Fam. Have a good night. And Jill Walkbrit, hello. Welcome. Good to see you. And
are you ending?
No, we're not ending. I was telling somebody good night. Pam's family, good night.
Oh.
Tina, we were just mentioning Arby's, Jeff, and Tina does not like Arby's.
What? Why? What did you get?
It's usually the roast beef.
Do you want me to do it for you, Tina?
Thank you.
You're welcome.
Because Carlos will know what I'm talking about. You get a genuine roast beef sandwich. No.
Go ahead, but go ahead.
Arby's roast beef, it just tastes too processed and plastic to me.
Yeah, but you know what, Tina? That's sometimes what it makes it better than that ripoff joint next to your grandmother's place.
Oh, Beach, the one that's not there anymore?
No, Kelly's.
Oh, Kelly's. I'm not talking about Kelly's. Oh my god,
Kelly's is a ripoff.
Kelly's is a ripoff.
Yeah, Kelly's a ripoff.
Kelly's is a ripoff. I don't
know. Walt's is okay, but no, I love a good Arby's, Tina. Yeah, I'm sorry.
No, I can't.
But I knew you were going to say something like that, but no, I.
Sorry.
Oh yeah, that's Jim. The best part about driving down is to have Arby's on a ride down.
Arby's is so good.
I love Arby's.
Arby's, there's so much we don't have up here. You can't find a Hardee's up here. You can't find the, what's their partner one? It's Hardee's. No, it's something else. But a Hardee's burger is so much better than a McDonald's or a Burger King. I think a Checkers burger is so much better than a McDonald's.
I used to get at Arby's the giant roast beef, the half pound one, and then I would dip it. I would just take the sauce and put it in the other side of the container, the lid or whatever, and mix the Arby's sauce and the horsey sauce and just dip it. And that's my favorite way to eat Arby's. But I miss that. Jeff, I found sugar-free Heinz ketchup. And it's pretty good.
Everything that I've ever tried sugar-free, don't like.
It was pretty good. I also am having the Duke's Light mayonnaise. And it's not bad. So
yeah,
you have to learn to adapt, Jeff. That's what I'm thinking.
Zero. Just the aftertaste. Just can't get over, get past that.
Mm-hmm.
I just had a Cracker Barrel commercial on. I want Country Fried steak now.
Emily says, I don't think I've ever eaten at an Arby's.
What?
Don't start now. Don't start, Em. Don't do it.
We had a couple up here and they closed down. But like I said, I don't leave the property for much. But I'll leave for an Arby's sandwich.
Yeah, so good.
What's the small one? What's the small one, Jeff? The was it something in Swiss or is it cheddar?
Where?
What? At Arby's, the small sandwich, the one you got like four of them that day you picked me up.
I get the beef and cheddar when I.
That's what it is. The beef and cheddar. Yes, thank you.
Cheddar.
It's the right size. It's just because they have like Chris just said, they have the big half pound one. Mm-hmm. That even to me is a little too much. Takes a little bit of me out of me to eat that whole thing. But I can eat two small beef and cheddars.
Mom always gets the beef and cheddar, the small one.
Yeah.
I have never tried their French dip that they have at Arby's.
Oh, that's good.
Is it?
I've never gotten anything bad from Arby's. Maybe it's your Arby's, Tina. Have you tried Arby's and somewhere else?
Two different Arby's.
Where?
It's just too plasticky. It's fake and plastic. Oh.
There it is. Classic beef and cheddar. Oh my gosh.
There's nothing classic about that thing.
As soon as I see that, my mouth starts watering. It's like I'm like Pavlov's dog.
Have you tried the smokehouse brisket? I haven't had that one yet.
No. They have a half pound beef and cheddar?
Yeah.
With cheddar in two different places.
Two different places.
Yeah, see, I got that one by accident.
Double beef and cheddar.
That was the one I got when I took you to Chick-fil-A and him to McDonald's that night. I forgot what park we left, but Ethan didn't eat right. So I'm like, all right, we'll go get to McDonald's. Before I know it, I'm at Chick-fil-A, McDonald's. And then I said, screw it, I'm going to Arby's. I thought I was getting a small sandwich, and I ended up getting that beast.
So, Tina, the Arby's that you go to, do you see them slicing the roast beef right in front of you?
No.
They should be slicing it right when they make your sandwich.
Oh.
Problem with Tina is she's comparing, and I get what Tina's saying, because we have some local roast beef places up here.
And I don't mean kill.
She's just comparing it to the mom and pop local. Well, even though they only like 10 of them now, but
like, honestly, even if I go buy my own roast beef and it's got to be either Boar's Head or something else, Angus, whatever that word is, beef, medium rare. Because what you do is you take it home, you pack it into an onion roll, you put some cheese on it, some barbecue sauce and mayonnaise, and you pop it in the oven and you crisp it up and you get it. It's just, there's nothing like it. And it's like getting it back home, and I miss it so much. It's just different than Arby's.
So, Jeff, there's a secret menu item at Arby's. My cousin ordered it before and says it's amazing. But it's, and I just looked it up to verify, it's the meat mountain. They put everything that they sell on one sandwich.
Look at how plastic that looks.
So it's got the roast beef, the chicken, the turkey, the chicken, fried chicken. I think they used to put a piece of fish on it as well. All of the things, one sandwich.
Wow.
I had the fish sandwich from Popeyes Friday. Suzanne didn't like it. I finished hers, actually. I thought it was pretty good, to be honest with you, for a chicken place.
Yeah.
Hey, Chris, they had a burger at Arby's at one point. I don't know if they still have it there or not, but it was really good.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't think it's on the menu anymore.
Okay.
That was Joy speaking. We're all sharing here.
Yeah, I don't see it on the menu now. My brother likes their, and people are going to say I mispronounce it, so whatever. He likes their gyros or their euros or whatever you call them. That's what he always orders when he goes to
Arby's. I call it a gyro. I don't know what wrong too. Have you ever had like a real Greek place gyro or hero, whatever you want to call it? Those can be really good.
I haven't. We used to have a food truck that would come to work that was run by some Greeks. It was a Greek. They sold gyros and different things, and those were good. I guess that's the closest I've had to a real one.
So. Well, if it was owned by a Greek and not an Arby's, then it was a really good one.
Yeah.
Then it has me.
Did you do music trivia tonight?
So no, we didn't. I ran out of time and didn't get it all done. So we're going to do it next week. Sorry.
No, I just got home.
Yeah. I've worked on it all week and I still didn't get done. At 9:05, I walked into the house. I was like, I can't do it. I'm not a fourth of the way ready. So. In the white flag. Spaceship here says, I've never heard gyros pronounced with a G. It's euros. Well, yeah.
I've never heard it pronounced with a Y. We always call it gyros.
Right?
Mike Beachman, welcome in. Good to see you. Howdy.
Mike. Oh, this hot cocoa's kicking in.
Oof. Emily says, my favorite fries are sweet potato fries.
Yes. I love sweet potato fries.
They're pretty good, but they're not my favorite.
Oh, I love sweet potato. The barbecue sauce.
Fries are fries covered in like cheese sauce and then dipped in ranch and with bacon bits.
With bacon on them? Oh.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Outback used to make the best loaded fries.
Really?
With cheese and bacon. Mm-hmm. But the problem was, too, they were just way too salty.
Yeah.
What happened to Steve?
He had a phone call, he said.
Probably his mama.
I bet you it's not. I think Jeff nailed it, but okay.
What do you dip sweet potato fries in? Like, I have to dip my fries in something. What do you dip them in?
All I did was point. What the hell am I getting balloons for?
No, they sell sweet potato fries at a place over here, and they have a it's like a marshmallow sauce that they
marshmallow sauce.
It's a marshmallow sauce, yeah.
Dip it in ranch.
We get up here, yeah. Well, Suzanne says ranch, but we get up here. A lot of restaurants they give you it's like a ranch sauce, but it's spicy. It's a it's an aioli thing. Darn it, I can't think of what kind, but.
See, Stevie K says ranch. Emily said sugar, LOL. I was wondering if it was like the brown sugar butter like they give you to put on a baked potato. Is that what
you do? See, do you put sugar or salt on your sweet potatoes?
We usually do sugar here, but...
Sugar.
I do salt. Suzanne yelled at me once. I made homemade sweet potato fries, and she's like, why are you putting a whole bunch of salt on it?
I'll be honest. I don't really eat many baked sweet potatoes. Yeah.
Angela's been on a sweet potato kick. She's been making, she bought a bunch of sweet potatoes and she bakes it for like
an hour. I grew up on a lot of them. I love sweet potato. Especially baked ones, yeah.
I like sweet potato casserole.
That's good too. And Jeff had some today, so this brought it up because you brought about the onion rings. What do you dip your onion rings in? I'm sorry, you brought up sweet potatoes and dipping, but what do you dip your onion rings in?
Ketchup.
That's it. Nobody else. Okay, good.
Ketchup.
So you're,
yeah.
I don't dip mine.
Up here, we use like. Well, I don't know. I don't even know what it's called, but they call it onion ring sauce. But again, it's like an aioli. It's smoky.
Oh, Chris Dice at a Thousand Island.
Oh, yeah.
I like that. Dad loves to go to Texas Roadhouse. Mm. And I like their cactus blossom or whatever they call it, that onion thing.
Yeah.
That spicy the sauce ranch that comes sauce. With it.
Yes.
Oh, that stuff is good.
Yeah. See, up here, that's what they give. All the restaurants that serve onion rings, that's what they give with them.
Every time he orders one, I'll ask him for extra cups of that sauce because I have to have my own cup because I'm going to go through it. That thing is so good. Emily, LSU mom says for onion rings, I like remoulade type sauce or ketchup. Horseradish says in like, sorry, Joy, were you saying something?
I'm like, was that Joy trying to talk again? Everybody
I was just saying that I don't think the blooming onion at Outback doesn't need sauce. I mean, I know that comes with sauce, but you can eat it without. It's got a good taste.
Yeah.
That's what I hate about going to those restaurants because Suzanne and I go out a lot alone. It's like you can't order a blooming onion because we're not going to finish it.
Yeah.
Just me and her. And so it's like, I want one. Because I love them, but I can't, justify buying it. And she eats like three little pieces of it. And then I got to like look at the rest of me like, should I give myself another heart attack or just throw the money away?
Yeah.
And the heart attack usually wins. But
the heart attack, yeah. That,
yeah
that.
I mean, yeah.
I took the parents to Costco Thursday. They needed to go get some stuff. So I took them to Costco. Dad hadn't been there in a long time. Took them for a day out. We got ready to leave and they were like, let's go get something to eat. And I'm sitting here thinking, okay, where can I take you to eat that I can get like the smallest portion ever made of something I can eat? And finally I was like, how about we go over here because our Costco is right next to the mall. I was like, why don't we go to the food court at the mall? I hadn't been to the mall in like years. And and they hadn't either. So we went to the food court and got Japanese at this little place. That was really good. And the boy child came home that night and saw one of the takeout plates. And he's like, that looks like a Jade Express takeout plate. And we were like, yep. He's like, I love that place so much. And he went on talking for like 20 minutes about Jade Express because he goes there while he's working sometimes.
I miss eating at mall food courts. And I know everyone had to have the same thing. Everybody remember the bourbon chicken place?
Yes.
It's like every mall food court had that bourbon chicken where they put six scoops of chicken and then a little side of like vegetable and a little side of rice. I'm like, damn, I don't, and it was all for like $6.
I ordered at this place because neither one of them were fried. I got the teriyaki chicken and I got one that was like a pepper chicken. She said, do you want the small tray or the big one? Because I was like, I just want the two meats, no sides, just the two meats. I was like, I'll do the small one. So the small one was in one of those little square takeout containers. I swear, she packed that thing so full.
They do.
I mean, that container had to weigh like 8 pounds. It was, I mean, all the way to the top. You couldn't fit another piece of chicken into that container. It was crazy. And it was $6. She charged me $5.99 for it.
Yeah. Wow. I don't know how those people in those malls make money. Then again, maybe that's why malls are all closing now.
Evan said that they like to go in there after 7 o'clock. He said, cause the mall closes at 8, or that place closes at 8. So from 7 to 8, they mark all the dishes down to 50% off. So you can get a 2-meat plate that's normally $13 for like $5.99. He said, and you just go in there and you just load up. He said they'll have a line across the food court of people wanting to order.
Just wait.
Yeah.
Watching the clock.
So
has anybody been to Citrico's? Anyone?
No.
Yes.
Are we going to talk about pork chops right now?
Mm-hmm. We're going to talk about pork chops. I've had pork chops on my mind all day today.
I know you have.
Did you like it, Tina?
I did like it. It was really good.
What'd you get there?
I don't remember. I have pictures. I think I have pictures, actually. Hold on. If I can go. Oops. I won't find
them. I've been having dreams about their pork chop.
Are the pork chops tender, Jeff? Because I don't like pork chops.
It chewed itself on the way down, Chris.
Really?
That's how tender, yes.
How thick was it?
Oh, my God. It chewed itself.
Oh, my God.
I'm curious.
I might schedule a Citrico's tomorrow.
How thick was it? Was it one pork chop or two?
One,
right? And so it was really thick. Yeah.
Emery and Angela both got it.
See, I'm not a fan of the thick pork chops. We have a restaurant up. Remember when I got it up here? We have a restaurant up here. Really good. I ended up going with it because I'm like, I like pork chops. And I don't know. To me, it was, I just don't like it when it's that thick. I don't feel like it's cooked right.
Oh, this was cooked right.
I finally recovered this afternoon from the anaphylactic shock I got when you showed that peanut butter sauce on that sundae this morning.
I licked that goblet clean. That peanut butter was so good on that, Chris.
You kept talking about how good it was. The pictures you showed looked really good. Like it was a lot. That was a lot of ice cream and brownie.
They said it was 2 scoops of ice cream in that thing. There had to be more than 2 scoops. Because all 4 of us ate it for, I mean, I dipped in there like 3 times.
It looked like 2 pints. It was.
Yeah. That was more than 2 scoops.
Jeanette says, I've never ordered a pork chop at a restaurant.
Me either.
Jeanette gets a bye today because it's her anniversary. Well, she's got like 35 minutes left, but she's bad mouthing onion rings and she's bad mouthing pork chops. She gets a bye because it's her anniversary. Okay.
Jeff, I'm sorry.
I tend to order things like that when it's not. This is going to sound weird, but if I ain't paying for it, I'm willing to try anything new. Like if somebody gives us a gift card to a restaurant for Christmas or something, I'm like, I'm going to try something new. It was my money. Or when a boss is like, hey, you know, go have a business meeting by yourself with your wife. And I'm like, oh, good. Business is paying for it. I'll try this. I learned my lesson by having a tuna steak once at a local restaurant. I'm like, oh, that was not a good idea.
Why? Tuna steak is amazing.
Well, I'm used to the way the Portuguese make it. And this was nowhere close to it. So it was like eating a pork chop, to be honest with you. It was thick. It was, you know, to me, not cooked the way I like it.
Welcome in, Hatbox Ghost. Good to see you, Gary. There was a local really nice restaurant that we used to go to when I was back in the day when I was married. We'd go out on date night too. But they would do a pork chop and they would kind of serve it butterflied and it was marinated in like a teriyaki sauce. That was really tender and it was so good. That was the only place that I would really order pork chops because normally I don't like them because they're usually every time I've got one, it's been tough or gristly.
Right.
Or,
yeah. Well, it's hard to cook something that thick.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, Jeff wants more shrimp and grits.
Listen, that was so funny. Last night, Jason and I went out to eat, and he got this, which was an Italian restaurant, and the portion size was huge. It was fried calamari with, like, cherry peppers and stuff mixed in it with some sauce. And he's a couple of bites in, he's feeling the heat, and all of a sudden he goes, whew, now I know how Jeff felt. And I go, you going to be able to pack that all in like Jeff did? And he's like, I'm going for it. He didn't do it, Jeff. He didn't.
Man up, Jason. Man up.
Was it spicier than a combo? The gumbo?
Yes.
American, was it?
It was spicier than the gumbo.
Really?
Yes.
Oh. I mean, I didn't find the gumbo too spicy, but it was spicy. So if this is definitely spicier than that, then I know you're not a big spice fan, so I can imagine that it
really I had happened. The gumbo to Angela made me take a bite of her gumbo tonight. And yeah. I took a bite of her gumbo. I needed a drink after every bite of that shrimp and grits.
The funniest part of that was when she leaned in on Steve's camera and she said, Jeff is a weenie.
Yeah, she did. She called me out in front of all 14,000 people watching.
Oh, it was the best.
How good was the cherry vanilla or the vanilla Coke or whatever it was?
The vanilla Coke was bussin', Chris. It was bussin'.
I hope so as much of it as you got.
Oh my gosh. Well, Ron got the vanilla in his Orange Fanta. It was so good.
Has anybody tried the new spiced Coca-Cola that they just came out with?
No. Steve, yes, you heard correctly. Sorry. Somebody was talking about that in Jeff's chat today. Spiced Coke or something.
Stephen K says it's gross.
What kind of spice is it?
I don't drink soda anymore, so.
The commercial.
I saw it had like raspberry and other spices or something in it.
Raspberry is not a spice.
Yeah, that's why I said raspberry and spices.
I know, but raspberry, that's such a weird combination.
The our grocery store actually had it even in the Coke Zero version. I was like, you can't get Sprite Zero, but you're going to have spiced Coke Zero. bro. That's weird, but okay. I had the coffee Coke and it was good, said Disneyland fan. I never saw the coffee Coke.
Back to the shrimp and grits. That was a big portion.
That was a lot.
And there was a lot of shrimp in there.
Was there?
So I thought that was a pretty good deal for the price.
There was a lot of shrimp, which is why I thought it would have been cooled down a little bit for him.
Well, that's shrimp.
Usually when you order shrimp and grits, you get like three or four shrimp and that's it.
This thing was overloaded with shrimp.
Yeah. She put a lot of shrimp in there for me.
It looked good. It looked like it was glowing hot, but it looked good.
All that I know would be the Cajun sauce, Chris.
Mm-hmm.
The first 2 minutes of you guys sitting down was more interaction than what Steve and I and Mike got throughout the whole evening the night we went. I looked at Suzanne. I'm like, I'd take this woman all day long.
She was awesome.
And all I saw was like the first couple of minutes before I had to go to bed. I'm like, this woman's amazing.
She was really good. You haven't had her before, have you, Steve?
I've not. Her name was Amanda. I've not had her, but the one that Carlos and I got,
have you not seen her? Feel like but she, prime you, time. You didn't see her at all that night?
No.
God, I hope.
Maybe yeah, she was on loan from the Brown Derby.
That's possible. That's no, that one, she was just one mean SO, you know what? My luck, we'll get her again in a couple of weeks. I swear to God, if I see blue hair walking towards me, I'm taking my family, leaving the restaurant. That's it. We're out.
That's a good meal, though, that 50-50 is prime time. Always a good meal.
Yeah.
It's worth the money. Not expensive at all for Disney.
It's $28 for the pot roast and the potatoes. And for Disney prices, that's incredible.
Suzanne's screaming over there, whispering, I love pot roast. Yes, we know that, Suzanne.
I think mine was $27.
Yeah, it's good pricing all around.
The plat is only, the sample is only what, $30?
Yeah.
31? It's like, yeah, 29 or 30, something like that.
Yeah, it's not bad.
She's like, now you are making me want to eat you, Carlos.
Afraid to eat with me, Jeanette? No, you're going to have a lot of fun, Jeanette. You're going to love eating with us.
Carlos, I still miss the burger at Brown Derby.
I do.
Carlos has a tendency to either draw attention to himself or make attention if he's not getting what he needs. So.
Says the man that talked his way out of the menu, the prefix menu at Space. Space 220. Hey. Talk about getting what you want. Don't get me wrong. Thank you. It worked out perfectly. I don't want this menu. Can you bring me the other menu? I am Steve from Steve's World. Damn it.
She brought us another menu, didn't she?
She did. She was great, that waitress. That waitress.
She was fantastic.
She was something else.
So is this a secret, super secret drawing you're doing, Steve?
No.
Well, let's see what you got.
Okay, one second. Oh, hi.
Oh, Lilo and Stitch.
Working on it. Nice. Working on it.
Nice, nice.
Chris, I gotta go.
All right, Tina.
Bye, Gina.
Thanks for hanging out.
Bye. Bye, guys.
Bye, Tina.
Have a good night. Jeanette says, I booked the Space 220 Lounge for Victoria and I in May. Teach me your tricks.
You don't need tricks. You nailed it. You nailed it by getting a lounge. And that's what I got to try to get for me and Suzanne this trip. If not, it's going to have to be for September, but.
So the lounge isn't walk-up. You have to book it in advance as well?
Yes. Yeah. But the trick is, and Steve's got a, I think a pencil in his mouth. So yeah, the thing is, mention Steve's
paintbrush.
Name. That's a paintbrush. But Suzanne, yeah, if you mention Steve's name, you get exactly what you want, which is absolutely nothing. No, the trick is, and Steve knew this already. The lounge menu, one is a la carte, which works out better for you than a prefix. But food wise, the lounge menu gives you an option of six or eight appetizers that can be ordered and eaten as your meal. It also has only three entrees, which a lot of people might look at and be like, well, I only get three picks. Again, the appetizers you can make into a meal. Where the prefix is, you get only three appetizers to pick from and more entrees. Yeah. So it's to me, I looked at both menus. The lounge menu is the way to go. You can eat well by just ordering an appetizer. You can eat well by ordering two appetizers. I proved that. Plus my meal. But like the lady explained, for lunch, the prefix price was 50-something bucks.
Yep.
I ordered two appetizers and an entree for myself, and it cost me the same price, give or take. Actually, it was a couple of more bucks, but still.
Those appetizers looked amazing, too. I mean,
they were great. Listen,
they were full-size appetizers.
They were. I was expecting, and I told Steve straight out, I mean, it's Disney. I was expecting, I ordered the wings. I'm like, all right, they're going to give me like six wings. No, there was a good 10 wings on that plate.
And they were big.
And they were big. And the sliders, there was just two sliders, but it came with fries. So if you're not a big...
Yeah, the sliders were a meal in themselves.
Right. If you're not a big eater and you just want the experience, I really highly recommend getting the sliders because it's two sliders, the fries, for like, what was it, 16 bucks, 18 bucks?
Yeah, it was ridiculous.
Yeah, I mean, you get the experience of being inside, which is what a lot of people like to see. And yeah, and you just said, Angela just said it, they give you a lot of food. I was not expecting that much food.
I've never got in there, but I would like
to. I want to take Suzanne this trip in April because we have like 3 days where we have no dining plans. And I saved it purposely for that. But I want to get her into the lounge or, again, get in there and say, I know Steve's world. Can you bring me the lounge menu? you know, that's
do you take the same ride to get to the lounge as you do like the regular?
It's all in the same spot.
Oh. Yeah.
There's just special seating right here that says lounge and it's all the same. I mean, there's literally an open area.
Uh-huh.
Half of these seats are lounge. Half of these seats are restaurant. Yeah.
Okay.
Like, and they only have us, like 10 seats for it.
Yeah. That helped us. Cause where we sat, I mean, I could have served myself at the bar. So we
were right next
you
to
know, I could have used that as saying like, well, I'm in the lounge area. I want the lounge menu. You know, if we needed, we didn't need to be rude about it. Cause again, she was great. But again, you get the experience, you get the food. It's the lounge is perfect. That's because again, you might get that waiter if you're sitting over by the glass by the windows, where it's going to be like, no, you're sitting here. You need to order the prefix. And if you go for dinner, it's 80 bucks. I don't think it's worth $80. The lunch one, you know, is it worth 50 something? Maybe.
I think, well, they changed their menu and they took a couple things off. Before, when I ate it, I thought it was worth $80. Right. And I actually paid more than that because I got the upscale ribeye. It was the best steak I'd ever had and the best salad I ever had, which I was just informed they no longer have that lettuce.
That's right, yeah. Mm. She told you that, yeah. Listen, we got the steak frites, both Steve and I. I thought it was really good. I thought the steak frites at Steakhouse 71 was just a little bit better, but it's a really big size steak frites. It's a steak. It's a good 8-10 ounce steak that they gave us. Yeah. You know, that alone without appetizers is a great, it was a great price, 28 bucks, 30 bucks, something like that. Well worth it. And when you, Suzanne asked that, when you just said the ride, Suzanne asked if there was a way to get in without going on that ride. And I explained to her what the ride was. So, yes, she can get in.
Yeah.
Just, you know,
look
the other way.
Snickerdoodle added it to our list. She said we may need multiple trips with how long this list is getting. We can work on that, Snickerdoodle. And Spaceship here said ride with quotes. Next thing I'll hear is that the hydrolators in Living Seas aren't real.
I enjoyed it. I didn't think I was. I wanted to do it, you know, because I figured I don't have the kids to pay for or Suzanne the picky eater. Actually, she's not a picky eater, but, you know, but yeah, it was fun. And the food was really good.
Is there a, since we're on Epcot right now, is there a restaurant at Epcot you will not go back to?
Electric Umbrella.
I mean, I'm not a fan of some of them, but I don't think there's anything that I wouldn't go back to.
There's still a few I haven't tried, so.
I mean, yeah. I've never eaten that, and I probably never will go to Acres Fouche because I saw the menu, and it's just disgusting.
It is not.
I've been there.
Shut your mouth, sir.
Bite your tongue.
Well, and I'm gonna throw one at you too, Steve, because I told you this in person. I guess Chris, this would be mine, but ever since they changed the menu at Garden Grill for lunch and dinner, I prefer not to go back to
Garden Grill's now one of my favorites.
Yeah, see, I'm not a fan of the because they've turned it more barbecue-ish.
No,
compared to what it was,
it's sirloin steak and turkey, and it's no barbecue in it whatsoever.
I wonder if they changed it again, because I'm telling you, this is what Suzanne and I saw, and I'm like, we're not going back there.
Jeff and I ate there about 2.5 months ago, and Mike and I and Rhonda ate there about a month and a half ago. It was fantastic.
Delicious. Oh, I got to look at the menu again, because it was just plain turkey, pot roast.
It's definitely not that. It's a sirloin steak with chimichurri, and it's also roasted turkey. And then you got... I don't remember what all the sides were. Just a ton of it. Cornbread. You've got
mac and cheese. And
apple pie and ice cream for dessert.
Not a lot of people talk about the San Angel or whatever it is in the Mexico Pavilion.
That's good.
We used to eat there. The family, when we went down, used to eat there a lot, and we always enjoyed it.
Mm-hmm. I like it.
I've never eaten... See, y'all, Carlos specifically keeps telling me I need to try in France the great place or whatever it is back there.
Me? I mentioned the bakery all the time.
The bakery. The crepery,
not yeah. The crepe. The crepe. The crepes are dog water.
No, yeah, they're not good.
No, the bakery.
I don't like crepes, so I wouldn't highly. No, the bakery.
That's what I meant. Yeah.
Yeah. No, the bakery. I mean, you.
Not bad.
Well. Yeah, it says the picky eater.
The bakery is wonderful.
The bakery, Suzanne and I, we can make, and we do, we'll make a meal out of it and not eat the rest of the day. But again, we order a lot. Like we'll get, you know, a sandwich, two sandwiches, two soups, desserts. Yeah. And I'm telling you, we'll leave there probably like $40, $45 for the both of us. And it'll fill us up. You get a large baguette. Or you get a small one with each soup.
Yeah.
So that fills you up too. Plus your sandwich. The sandwiches are great.
I've also never eaten at whatever's over there in Morocco, Spice Road Table or whatever.
You don't need to.
Yeah.
Chris. It's not that bad. Morocco has some good.
When somebody has to say it's not that bad, you know it's not great.
Steve, you...
We have a friend that loves, well, she has a coworker that loves that freaking place.
Mm. I ate there with Dean from the live place. It was good.
Have you been a chef to France lately?
They have recently? A good steak over there.
I've never been, but I've heard it's gone up, it's gone down. I've
not been there in a while, but it was good the last time I ate there.
Angela. Nicole says, I don't know who to believe, Steve or Jeff.
Yeah, believe the guy that puts a half
Jeff couldn't even eat shrimp and grits that everybody told him was mild.
Yeah.
I know a lot of people knock it, but I always enjoy the fish and chips at Rose and Crown. I think it's good.
You talking about the fish and chip store, or are you talking about actual?
Either one.
In Rose and Crown.
Yeah, either one. I'm good with either one. I've done both in a pinch. So, but I've never been to Coral Reef.
Ooh.
I've never eaten at Garden Grill. I've never been to Tapanetto. That one's on.
That's one I haven't been to. I really want to.
That is one of my top five at Epcot.
I really want to try that one.
Yeah.
I knew I liked you.
Steve, we're going there for Peyton's birthday in July. You should come with us.
You're going where? Tapanito?
To Tapanito, yeah.
Ooh.
I want to try that one.
Joey, don't invite him.
Hey,
he's just gonna complain about it. You know what?
I don't complain about things that are good.
Oh, do you have any? Can you put some more pepper on that for me, please?
Oh man!
Listen, I started sneezing last time at 50s with him and Mike. I'm like, wow, what is that? Oh, it's this pepper.
Jan said she thought the honey sesame chicken was very good at Nine Dragons. I remember eating at Nine Dragons with the family back in the day. We thought it was good then. I haven't been to it. In
Is that the sit years. Down or the quick service?
Sit down.
That's the sit down. Yeah.
We ate there a couple months ago. It was good. I had the honey chicken too, Jan. And Jan is right.
I don't remember the food inside there, but I know the quick service one had two options. One was orange chicken, I think. I don't remember what the other one was. And it wasn't bad.
Chris, Snickerdoodle has Tempanito reserved for her birthday, but she doesn't have a trip booked yet.
Oh, wow.
Usually you do that the other way around, right?
Yeah.
I'm going to come down in December, Chris, just so you and I can go to a couple of restaurants, and then I'll come home.
That sounds good.
Just restaurants, man. Just
do that.
Me and you, we're going to go to Sanaa. Because Suzanne doesn't like it, so
that's another one Jeff can't handle.
No,
Jeff can handle. I have video. Jeff can handle it. He might cry, but he can handle.
He did,
it.
And he had a lot of milk there too.
Yeah,
every single one of those was too spicy.
Did you eat it? Listen, yeah. You did not.
I did. I was on the table right next to you.
You did not.
Listen, Jeff and I had the special sauce, the number 12, 13, 14, whatever the hell number it is. And I have video of him crying.
Yep.
I did not cry, but I did like run for my cup of water.
Zach was there the day I was with you, and he couldn't. I was like father like son. I felt bad for that kid.
Stephanie L, that's like a barbecue sauce that they give you at Liberty Tree. We had finished our meal, and Steve was like, "What's this sauce?" And then he licked it to taste it. He's like, "That's pretty good." And he just kept sitting there licking it.
Yeah, we need a new opening, Chris.
I was watching it earlier. I'm like, wow, I was sitting in the same spot. The camera was in the same spot. Yeah. I just needed the orange shirt.
Yeah, yeah. Mm. Creatures of habit.
Yep.
I want to see. I need to start either going to eat by myself when we're on family trips or do more solo trips because I need to go back.
I've never been to Le Cellier.
Oh, I love Le Cellier.
Never been there.
I've heard a lot of people say, though, that they don't like it. But I've heard way more people say it's one of the better ones on property.
Yeah.
And they have some kind of, what is it, Jeff? Cheese, potatoes, something, soup? Or
poutine.
What? soup. No, they got something that's like a soup that everybody raves over.
Potato leek. Is it potato leek soup?
Is it maybe it's cheese soup? It has something to do with cheese. Well,
it's the beer. Yeah. The beer.
The beer cheese soup.
Yeah.
Beer cheese soup?
Yes.
I don't know. I've never had that, but I love their steaks.
The food booth has the same thing.
Yeah.
I like the beer cheese with the pretzel rolls at Beer Garden.
Baseline.
I've never been to Baseline.
Baseline doesn't have, they got a charcuterie board and a monster pretzel, which is one of the better pretzels on property.
Brilliant. Thank you, like Steve. The rest of them.
Yeah. I wish they had, what bothers me about Disney is there's no like a nacho cheese anywhere except AMC, and it's like fake nacho cheese. Like everything is either beer cheese or cheddar cheese, and there's no spice to it whatsoever.
Yeah.
Well, the one at Baseline, it's got a little kick to it.
But it was beer cheese though.
Yeah. I've
never been to Shula's, Tina.
Shula's is good too.
Shula's
is like a upper end.
I think Baseline has the second best pretzel on property, right behind Polite Pig.
Polite Pig has a pretzel?
Yeah, really good. I think a lot better than Baseline's.
I will say that I do like the pretzel at the theater.
Where?
The theater, the AMC Regal or AMC movie theater. It's a monster thing. Monster pretzel, and at least they have some spice in their cheese, even though it's not the greatest cheese in the world.
Are those Wetzel pretzels that are over in?
Oh, Greece? I forgot about Wetzels. Those are some good pretzels. They're buttery. They have I have them put extra butter and salt on them because they don't ever put any on it in the first time, and then you shake it all down so all the salt goes to the bottom of the bag and. Man, they're just some good pretzels.
That's Steve's favorite restaurant.
Nope, never again.
Listen, I might have to take Ethan this trip because somebody kind of like promised him.
You promised him sci-fi?
He loves it there.
Oh my gosh. Well, this is his birthday. So, hey, Carlos, I won't be there that day.
No, not in July. No, I might have to take him now in April, but I told him. We're going to Mama Melrose for the first time. I'm sick of talking bad about it, and I've never been.
Yeah, you can't talk bad about it if you've never been.
Right. Yeah. I talk bad about it. Like I've heard like,
it's not things. It's so hit or miss.
It is.
I wanted spaghetti one day, and the guy talked me into that steak in my knee with my knees. It tastes burnt because it's a charred with a wine sauce or something like that. And it just tastes like burnt charcoal to me. Then when I went with Chris, we had our little date night that we went on. and I had pasta. It was fantastic, I thought. I thought it was great. Then Corey and I went there not too long ago. And I had the pasta, and it wasn't good again. So I don't know. It's just like hit or miss for me.
I know people say that. Every time I've been, it's been pretty good. But maybe it's just my
dumb luck. And that's all I've heard is stories like that. You know, it's good, it's bad, it's good, it's bad. And like, you know what? Suzanne's always wanted to go, so we're going to go. And I might take him to, like, sci-fi first at 11 just to have him eat. Let him give him his wish and then go to Mama Melrose and eat at 12:40. So,
in my opinion, Tony's downtown in Magic Kingdom is way superior to Mama Melrose.
See? And I've heard it's way worse. See? There you go.
This is the downfall of being a super taster. Your taste buds are all messed up.
Go get you some cheese logs, which are ridiculous. They're 12 inches long. You get two of them.
You know how many people say the steak at Mama Melrose is one of the best on property?
I've had it. It's not. Well, and I love steak. It is one of the worst I've ever had.
And there you go. See, but I'm saying what I've heard. I've never been, but.
I'm not joking. So it has a wine sauce on it, and it's charred. It is a charred steak. That's the name of it. Unless they've changed it since the last time I've had it. It is called a charred something steak, and it tastes just like charcoal, like it's been burned.
Perfect. It's called flavor. It's flavor.
It is, There is flavor, and then there is charred, which is like burned. I guess if you look, dude, I'm not. If you like going out and eating charcoal briquettes, I don't. I'm not gonna judge you.
I still want to get over and try at some point Steakhouse 71.
Oh my gosh, Chris!
I've never been there.
All right, so Sanaa Steakhouse 71, Chris. That's where we're going.
Can we start with what have you had? That'd be a shorter list. No, Mama Melrose has had. I've had good experiences there, but I've also had some bad ones with the steak.
In my defense, I've only had Steakhouse 71 for lunch, but not one bad meal. Oh, we've had breakfast too. Not one bad meal yet.
This is going to sound silly, but I haven't been to this one in Boy Child's 19, so I haven't been to this place in like 11 years, 12 years. I want to go and I want to do breakfast at the Crystal Palace.
Oh,
I don't know why, but I want to do it again.
Breakfast is what you want to eat if you're going to eat. Otherwise, it's the same as every other restaurant on property. You're just going for different characters.
It is not.
The buffet is the exact same buffet as 1900 Park Fair, Chef Mickey's. They're all the exact same food. Exact same food, except for breakfast.
Nope. I disagree.
You're allowed to, but this is not an opinion thing. This is a factual
thing. Steve started talking, and you can't see Jeff's belly, but I saw the deep breath.
I think I'm going to have to drop out. I can't take this.
Tell me what's on that menu, Jeffrey, that's different than everything else. It's the same carving station with the same.
What do we compare Crystal Palace to? Which one?
Chef Mickey's 1900 Park Fair. What else is the same? Mini Seasonal Dine is the same kind of food, but they decorate it to be the theme. All those buffets are all the exact same thing.
They are not. Like, yeah. They had a bunch of fish dishes at Crystal Palace, like shrimp.
They have shrimp on the other ones.
Well, 1900 is completely different, and we'll find out in 3 weeks.
Well, 1900 may be completely different now after they closed it.
But even back then, listen, 1900 was the only place you can go get freaking hot dogs. It was like a big pot of hot dogs there in 1900.
But, okay, the stuff that adults eat, like the carving station, right, things like that, is exactly the same.
Steve, what's different for breakfast than the other ones?
I haven't done the breakfast. I'm just talking about the dinners.
Well, you said you want to do the breakfast because the other ones are all the same.
Oh, because if you go to if you look at the breakfast menu on the Crystal Palace, they have some really cool stuff on there, and everybody talks about how good it is.
Because I've done Chef Mickey and I've done Kate May, and to me they were both mediocre. So we're doing Crystal Palace.
I'm not a fan of Chef Mickey's breakfast. I've never done Kate May's.
We're doing Crystal Palace for my granddaughter's birthday in September. Or I know we're doing it, but whatever. I think that's the day.
Yeah.
And I already told Suzanne, I think we're just going for the mediocre food again, just like Kate May and Chef Mickey, which is the same. I agree with you, Steve, on that part, that a lot of those buffets are all the same food.
Here's your lunch dinner menu for Crystal Palace. Seasonal salads, country fried chicken with black pepper gravy, fresh seasonal vegetables, seasonal pasta, mashed potatoes, carved prime rib, shrimp creole, and assorted desserts.
Shrimp creole. Remember that. Shrimp creole.
I don't even know what that is.
Exactly.
You wouldn't.
Because I can't eat seafood.
I think you can. Let's say that out loud.
You know what I hate, too, is they don't post everything. Because if you've been to these buffets and you like read that list, I'm like, oh, there's 8 things there. And then you get there and there's like 15. Like, where was the rest of this?
That was everything that they had on the.
They usually won't tell you. They'll have a carving station. They'll say seasonal vegetables, seasonal whatever, and that's all they ever have on these menus.
That's all it says.
Chris, but they have other offerings.
Look at the new 1900 menu.
So that's what's that look like? Because I'm going there with Carlos, and I don't know what that is.
That's what I was pulling up next. Well,
Jeff will be there too, so maybe we're all going to get a rude awakening that night.
Oh, Jeff's going to the 1900 Park Fair?
Yeah.
Carlos, I'm feeling a little sick, whatever day that was.
So your dinner menu at 1900 Park Fair, partial listings, but gosh, yeah. What a list. Here you go. Peel and eat shrimp with cocktail sauce.
Baked not the salmon. Same as shrimp Creole.
Nope.
I said this is the old menu. This is brand new. It's not even open yet. Carry on, Chris.
Baked salmon with saffron lemon butter, prime rib, roasted garlic sausage with tomato, herbs, and braised cabbage.
That sounds amazing.
Grand Floridian strawberry soup with fresh strawberries and whipped cream. Couscous salad with dried fruits, almonds, mint, and parsley. Mashed potatoes, green beans. Then we're skipping over to Tiana's gumbo with spicy andouille sausage. There you go, Jeff. A carving station.
Carving, okay.
Curry roasted chicken. Impossible sausage and zucchini noodles. Mediterranean kale salad. Focaccia with sun-dried tomato and herbs. Glazed carrots. Classic favorites for kids, vanilla cupcakes, lemon blueberries.
Oh, that's on the menu now?
Yep.
Oh, so they've updated it because when it first came out, I'm like, Suzanne, there's no kids menu. We're screwed.
Yeah, it says classic favorites for children.
So at least they added.
So they've got it's a slightly different menu. They've got a couple extra things on there, but it's all still the basic. Carving station, potatoes and gravy, or potatoes, green beans, all that. But that is a different menu, finally, than what it normally is.
This breakfast menu sounds pretty good.
Politics, Steve.
It does. The breakfast one looks pretty good, too.
I don't know how you don't know it's the same food you're eating.
It's not the same food.
The breakfast menu at 1900 is bread pudding with vanilla, cream, and jalice, I guess. The strawberry soup, guava and cream cheese Danish, beef and potato hash. Omelet selections, cheesy scrambled eggs, pork sausage, biscuits and gravy, carved ham, smoked salmon, spiced tofu scramble with vegetables, donut holes, double chocolate muffin, cinnamon pull-apart bread, classic eggs Benedict with hollandaise sauce, scrambled eggs, bacon, chicken sausage, Mickey-shaped waffles, croissant breakfast pizza, cheesy potato casserole, and classic favorites for children.
Can we go there instead of Crystal Palace in September?
Did you say cinnamon pull-apart bread?
Cinnamon pull-apart bread.
Oh, man, that sounds good.
I'd rather go there than Crystal Palace for breakfast.
That sounds
good. No, they have the same thing, Carlos. Don't worry.
No, I said the breakfasts are different.
For breakfast,
this is your problem from the other night when you didn't listen to the waitress when she was trying to tell you. You only hear what you want to hear.
Fun fact.
This is on a Monday night, so Steve will be streaming from 1900 Park Fair, and we can have this argument there about.
I will indeed.
Breakfast at 1900 Park Fair is $54 for adults and
for breakfast,
$34 for children.
Yeah, dinner is 66.
Yeah, but that's a character meal.
So it's breakfast, I think.
I got engaged to Drizella there one day.
Yeah, but they changed the character, Steve. It's not fun anymore.
Well, who's the characters now?
Oh, it's all been changed. They've.
Oh my god, it's still Cinderella.
Oh my god, Cinderella, big deal. And now it's like it's not the sisters. It's Tiana.
Prince Ali.
It's Prince Ali. He came out of nowhere to come at the freaking 90s.
Aladdin? Prince Ali? Aladdin.
Yes.
What?
Maribel. Maribel's hanging around.
So you got, wait. Tiana, Aladdin, and Maribel. How does that fall together?
And Cinderella.
And Cinderella. They're all, yeah.
The sisters were what made that thing bearable in the first place.
Oh my God. Yes, Steve. Yep.
You meet characters from classic Disney films as well as newer favorites like Encanto and The Princess and the Frog. each character is known for making a wish and making their wish come true.
Look, I'm okay with the new characters. I just don't know how they fit in the whole theme of things. But I like those characters, so.
There you go.
Jeff, have you ever eaten Artist Point?
Yes, I have.
I want to try it, but the only problem is it's prefixed.
Well, don't worry.
I would eat the prime rib, but I don't think there's anything on the appetizer menu I would eat.
Look, you got to put your big boy pants on and just try some different foods.
Steve, I went there and I found something to eat. So if I can find something, you can find something.
Oh, no. Yeah,
because you asked for
on the appetizer?
Chicken nuggets.
Yeah.
That's different.
No, I had the prime rib.
The prime rib. What'd you get for the appetizer? Because there was like shepherd's pie, which is a no for me.
For appetizer?
Yeah, I think it's what it was.
Shepherd's pie for an appetizer?
I might be messing that up. Chris, can you look at Artist Point later?
What was that? Where am I looking?
Artist Point. It's over in Florida.
Do you need somebody to go to Artist Point with you, Steve?
I do. I want to try it.
How many dwarves come out?
Two, Grumpy and Dopey.
Grumpy and Dopey.
And yeah. Snow White and the Evil Queen.
See, I'd go for that. See, I'd go for those characters.
That's why I kind of want to try it.
Yeah, I'd go for that.
Experience storybook dining at Artist Point with Snow White. A delicious, fanciful dinner with visits from Snow White, Dopey, and Grumpy.
Well, and then the Evil Queen's off.
Yeah, she's evil like the queen. Beast. Yeah.
She's like the beast. You go meet her after the...
Yes. Evil Queen.
All right. So dinner at Artist Point is $65 for adults, $39 for children. Your appetizers are wild mushroom bisque, wicked shrimp cocktail, and hunter's pie, which is turkey and chicken, cranberry preserve, and crispy sauerkraut.
Yeah, see, I wouldn't eat in that.
I would do the first and the third one. I don't know if I'd do the shrimp cocktail.
I got the shrimp cocktail.
I got the shrimp cocktail.
I'd do the soup. Once the soup and I don't know, that just sounded weird having like a pie for appetizer.
Yeah, with chicken and turkey and whatever.
Yeah. I mean, yeah, you're right. It's close to a shepherd pie or a chicken pot pie. Something.
Sorry, it was called a hunter's pie.
Yeah.
The wicked shrimp cocktail is Bloody Mary vinaigrette, seaweed salad, spiced house-made seasoning.
Sounds different.
Salad, or is it just a shrimp cocktail?
It's cocktail, but I guess it comes with a salad too. I don't know.
That makes it interesting. Okay.
And then here's your entrees. You choose one. There is the cottage beef stroganoff, a tender beef preserved vegetables, spatzel, mushrooms, and aged cow milk cheese. Then there's a stroll through nature, which is asparagus, leeks, arugula, gnocchi,
it's vegetable. Sage,
parmesan. Yes, that's the plant-based option.
Yeah, move on.
Brothers Grimm herb chicken, which is also has cauliflower puree, roasted vegetables, and chicken juice.
Chicken
juice. There you go.
Chicken juice. What they teach us. What they teach us not to touch.
Is it J-U-S
right away? This needs to be to us.
There's the sorcerous spell of trickin' chicken. Which is the same thing, but it's plant-based, apparently.
So it's not chicken.
It is not chicken. There's the Royal Prime Rib Roast.
There we go.
With horseradish, mashed potatoes, carrots, and juice. Magic Mirror Slow Braised Pork Shank.
Mm.
Oh,
and Bashful Sustainable Fish.
See, I can do the chicken, the pork, or the beef there, the prime rib.
And all else fails, I can go to the fish. So,
as long as they don't have any ketchup for the pork chops.
What's the dessert?
Dessert is Miner's Treasures, which is cookies and cream, panna cotta, and chocolate gems. the poison apple, which is dark chocolate apple mousse sour center.
I've had that. It's good.
The fairy tale gooseberry tart with meringue and gooseberry. And then the hunter's gift to the queen.
You should get that one. That one's cool.
That's the one that's like the box with the smoke and like the chocolate. Mm-hmm. And all. Yeah,
it was cool.
Oh, wow.
So you get one of each.
Yeah, you get
the all 64 bucks.
Yep.
Plus tax and tip. That's not.
And it's character meal.
Yeah, it's not. No, it's not too bad.
Your kids' entrees are grilled chicken, prime rib roast, and grilled fish of the day.
Well, never taking my kids there. So Suzanne will be just me and you. They didn't have grilled chicken.
What
say
was the first thing you said?
Grilled chicken.
Oh, yeah, my kids will get it.
All right, Chris, I got to drop, Chris. Sorry. I didn't realize it was.
I appreciate you coming tomorrow. In, sir. You got an early one tomorrow.
Is it tomorrow?
Jeffrey, as soon as Mike gets here, we're gonna schedule.
I know. You keep saying that.
It's all that. Look, everything there except this black bag. All these boxes and bags right here are all. Oh, and it's all. No, it's over there now. It's all to bring to your house to film.
I don't eat expired baby food.
It's not. Oh, I looked. It expires in 2025.
Jeff, it all tastes the same.
2025. All right. So we got the
year. November 2025.
All right. Thanks, Chris.
See you, buddy.
Thanks for coming in, bud.
All right. Bye. See you guys later.
Bye. Bye. He's a good dude, no matter how
animals more.
The animal kingdom, you said?
Yeah.
I'm looking forward to 1900. I'm glad it's open. I'm really glad it's open. It was the last restaurant not to open.
It's not open yet, right?
No. April.
Ooh. It's like a week or two.
April 10th. Yeah.
That's the prime rib from Artist Point.
That's yeah. Good.
That looks amazing.
That's one cut of meat I never.
Oh, got. You said?
Oh. Prime rib.
Oh, not a huge. It's got to be cooked for me. It can't be bleeding, but
they'll cook it. Yeah. So then it's not prime rib, Steve. That, you know, for me, I'd have to eat it the same way as you, but.
Then is that chocolate? Prime
rib. Yes. Mm-hmm. Oh, there. See there.
Wait a minute. Was that one little thing she pulled out, the dessert?
No, there's several pieces in there.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Is that what you got, Joy?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And it's got smoke coming out of it when you bring it to the table. It's cool.
So it's smoked chocolate?
Well, it's got the dry ice kind of thing. Just to make it look cool.
Here you go. This is them opening it.
Yeah, there you go.
That's and then they give you tongs to like take the chocolate out.
Oh, you take it out.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
That looks really cool. Are there any other restaurants I need to look up the menus for?
All of them.
They're all the same.
All of them, he says.
Well, painting. I'm good for a while.
Can I tell a joke, Chris?
Yes.
Okay. This is my stupid joke that I found today. It's illegal to laugh out loud in Hawaii. You have to keep it to aloha.
That's pretty good.
That's my dumb dad joke.
So Sanaa, Carlos, there's Sanaa and there's the Sanaa Lounge. Is it different menus?
Yes. Okay.
Which one should I look at?
Sanaa.
Okay.
I don't even know if you can get the bread service at the lounge, can you?
Yes. It's one of the only thing. It's one of the only meals you can get at the lounge. I think there's only two foods on the lounge menu. And the bread service is one of them.
The other one I'm always tempted to do for breakfast is Tusker House. Everybody talks about breakfast at Tusker House for some reason.
I've had Boma's really the only thing I will do for breakfast, but Tusker House is probably the next best thing for me for breakfast. It's different.
Wait, it's not all the same?
No, that's different. That one's a different one.
Where's Jeff when we need him right now? Hold on.
Look, I'm telling you, I've been to all these restaurants. They are the exact same cuts of meat on the carving station. They're the exact same. It's just whatever is in season.
Not the last one to open.
Now,
well, I
can't speak to the fish options because I don't get fish.
Suzanne just corrected me. Marrakesh hasn't opened yet, so 1900 is not the last one open.
Oh, yeah.
I don't think Restaurant Marrakesh is coming back open.
No, because, well, it might come back as a different restaurant. That's a hell of a building back there to leave.
Yeah.
But.
Yeah, I think they're going to redo that since Disney owns it now.
Yeah.
That's still just like a sitting area, basically, now, isn't it?
You can't even go into it.
I don't think you can go in. I think it's closed.
I saw somebody go into it. Tanya one day went into it, and they were having like a Disney Visa area.
Like a lounge?
One day in that lounge, yeah.
That's interesting.
They had like bottles of water and like little snacks or something. That was a couple of months back. So Sanaa's got the bread service, several different appetizers. I can't pronounce a lot of these entrees. Tandoori chicken, I see that.
The seafood curry is really freaking good.
Man, you know, I've been there a lot. I don't know how many times I've been there. I'm not 100% sure I've ever gotten anything but the bread service.
Really?
No, you can switch up the bread too. Right. I would highly recommend you do what you want to do, obviously, but I would highly recommend you ask for 3 pieces of garlic naan and 2 pieces of regular naan. They're bigger breads. They're going to go a lot better. And the other ones kind of just don't taste the greatest.
Yeah.
Their naan bread is
fantastic. I like just the regular naan.
There's 5. It says traditional naan, garlic ginger naan, spiced naan, onion kulcha, and paneer paratha.
So they've added another naan then, because there used to only be 2 naans. And 3 other ones. I'm pretty sure, because we've always asked for the 2 naans, all of that.
And then your accompaniments are cucumber rata, roasted red pepper hummus, mango chutney, tomato date jam, tamarind chutney, coriander chutney, a garlic pickle, red chili sambal, and spicy jalapeno lime pickle.
So I think the one you started out with first is the coolest one, and they get spicier. And then there's a special sauce you can ask for. It's the secret sauce.
Chris, is Evan's working right now? No, it's midnight. He's got to be home, right?
No, he's home. Yeah.
But he's not there with you?
No.
Okay.
He actually went to a friend's house to watch the race tonight.
I was going to say, the F1 race is on right now. I just realized that. And I'm all excited because Verstappen's already out. I don't know what happened, but I'm just
glad
somebody else is going to win today.
Who?
So he won't hear the Dutch national anthem tonight.
Nope. And it won't be 10 wins in a row for him. Thank freaking God.
Do you really got that many wins?
Yes.
In a row? Yeah, I think it was 9 last race.
He won all the races last year except for like 3.
Yeah. Seriously. He's on 9. I think he's on 9 in a row going back to last year.
What was his name?
Max Verstappen.
Max Verstappen.
I don't know what that means.
Amy says she gets the burger. So they've got a Sanaa burger, which is spiced mustard and pepadu goat cheese. Served with Sanaa chips and pickles. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, it's only on the lunch menu. Then a menu, it's not on there.
I have to be careful at a lot of restaurants like that because they tend to cook a lot with peanuts and that sort of stuff, and so it's hard for me to order a lot of places.
You don't want to really eat anywhere in Morocco.
Yeah.
I like curry, so that's what I had the one time I was there, had the seafood curry, and that was really good. Walt had the steak, and that looked good.
You've been there twice.
I've been there twice? Oh, we have been there twice. No, we're Pete. Once. Yeah, you've been once. That's right.
The one thing I don't mind in a lot, anyways, in Morocco, it's not spice or table. It's not Marrakesh. It's the one between the two that serves the kebabs. You know what I'm talking about? They have a chicken kebab that's pretty decent.
What's the one across? I call it a street. What's the one across the street? The one by the water.
That's Spice Road Table, I think. That's
Spice Road? Okay.
I believe that's Spice Road. And I think that's Spice Road Table and the far one at Marrakesh. I think it's the one in between the two.
Right. Marrakesh is all the way in the back.
Yeah.
The
last building. Yeah. And I think the one I might be wrong, but I think the one by the water is Spice Road.
It is.
All right, so the one in between actually is closed, right? It's just a
Tangerine Cafe. The Tangerine Cafe. Actually, yeah, that's the one by the water.
Quick service.
Hang on a minute. Tangerine Cafe might be the one by the water.
No, Spice Table is.
So they say no, Spice Table is.
I'm trying to remember which way I went counterclockwise. I remember seeing Spice Road and the Tangerine Cafe.
No, she's right. She's right. Spice Road is.
Oh, yeah. Tangerine Cafe must have the kebab.
By the table, by the water.
Oh, my God.
Yep. So, the chicken kebab, anyways, there is not terrible.
At Spice Road or?
At Tangerine Cafe.
Tangerine Cafe.
All right, I'm done painting for the night. I'm tired.
I was pulling up Boma. Boma's pricing is not bad for breakfast.
No, Boma's pricing for breakfast is amazing.
Dude, Boma in general is like the most unique restaurant on property when it comes to different flavors.
I wasn't a fan of the dinner.
Oh, really? See, it's my favorite.
I'm glad we went, you know, but I expected more African-inspired dishes at dinner than what I got.
The entire thing is African-inspired.
No, it's not.
It's boba tea, and the way it's prepared is all African seasonings and everything. That's why I like it so much.
I'm sorry. I expected more. When I went, I expected more. Like, I got more for breakfast.
I didn't like it all.
That whole first section on the buffet is more African-inspired for breakfast. With dinner, it was... I don't know.
The whole first section on the buffet is... the most unique African flavors.
I know it is. For dinner. Breakfast it was. I didn't find it for dinner.
Eat all the little sauces you can dip on, and it's got that curry or whatever it is, that seasoned
spice. I'll honestly say, man, I'm glad I went, but I didn't think it was worth the $60.
What is boba tea?
It's like a potato, some weird it's an African dish.
Love the breakfast. The only reason we're skipping it this year, where are we going instead? We're going somewhere else.
So the breakfast has got breakfast muffins, pancakes.
Oh, yeah, we're waffles, going to 19. Yeah, that's fine.
Breakfast potatoes, bacon sausage, cinnamon raisin bread pudding, carved ham, coconut steel cut oatmeal, turkey boba tea, omelets. Look pretty good. Cinnamon rolls, sticky buns. Deviled eggs with smoked salmon, composed yogurt parfait, and then avocado papaya grapefruit salad.
Not boba tea. Boba tea. Boba tea. No, Spaceship here said boba tea is African.
Oh.
It's one word.
B-O-B-O-T-I-E.
Yes. The thing I like about breakfast at Boma's, it's one of the reasons why, the only reason why we eat there, they have this big, huge bowl of bacon they put there, and you just grab whatever you want.
Yeah.
And it's good bacon.
It's right in the first section all the time. It's this tomato. It's not a soup. It's a stew. It's like a tomato stew.
You want me to read the whole menu?
For the dinner?
Boma breakfast? No, you don't
have for to. For dinner.
Oh, for dinner.
It probably just says African-inspired meals.
There's a lot here. Assorted breads. Berbera chickpea salad. Tunisian couscous and shrimp salad, spiced green beans and golden raisins, peanut rice or coconut rice, macaroni. Oh,
rice. There was one rice that was freaking amazing. That I'll give it. I forgot which one it was right now. Maybe it was the coconut one.
Macaroni and cheese, sweet corn pudding, lamb boba tea, oak roast pork ribs, Moroccan Harira,
African.
Yes. Pita with hummus and coriander, tubalihi, North African cauliflower salad, black-eyed peas, greens, and chakalaka. That's fun to say. Penne pasta marinara with and meatballs, chicken bites, olive oil herb crushed potatoes, Durban chicken, African spiced beef, strip loin, and butternut squash soup.
So the only thing on there that's not African is the chicken bites and the meatballs and pasta
and the pork ribs.
It's the sauce that's on them. That's complete. Have you not had the sauce?
I didn't. Yeah,
extremely spicy for those that are going to go eat it. That curry, I think it's a curry. Maybe me called curry ketchup. I can't remember what it is.
Hamilton's on it, a race. Jesus, everybody's dropping. Rye guy that Mr. Smoker himself says that those ribs were the best on property.
Pomas?
Yeah. And I'm sorry, I didn't think so, but
they're very good. Like I said, it is
their own in their palate. You know, I always wanted to try it. We did it, and I will never probably go back again for dinner. Breakfast? Yeah. Again, the only reason we're not going this trip, because we like going on Animal Kingdom Day, just because it's all the way out there, is because we're going to 1900 at night. But, you know, we'll be back.
My family's coming down in June, and we're staying at Animal Kingdom Lodge for 4 nights, and it's just so we can go to Boma's for dinner and breakfast.
There you go.
Joy, have you been there?
I have not. I don't know that I would find anything that I might like at there.
I don't know. Sure. I find, I eat a lot of the stuff. The green, I like green beans. They have the best green beans on property, in my opinion. They're not very spicy. But you would probably, if you like pork loin or sirloin, the beef loin is very good. It's just got seasoning on the outside. It's a rub. So you could literally cut that off if you wanted to. And they got some chicken. I mean, you could get the spice. African spice off of it, but they have, I mean, I'm picky, and that's, they got some good stuff there.
I love Yak and Yeti. I pulled up the Tusker House menu, and I hope their breakfast is more than what the menu says, because of all these breakfast menus, I get to Tusker House and they have pastries, breakfast meats, breakfast classics, and fruits.
So,
it's telling you, it's just like Beach Club, Hollywood and Vine. So it's going to agree with Steve. They're all the same.
This is the one I disagree with is not the same as the rest of the breakfast that I've had, but I've not had Beach Club or whatever else you just said. This one had some unique flavoring to it. Like the bacon here does not taste like the bacon everywhere else in the sausage. It was a good one, but it's a really cool character breakfast. You get Mickey, Minnie, Donald, and Goofy in their like safari attire.
They went back to buffet.
It was decent. I thought, maybe let me check. I think I've done a video on it before, because I know I filmed every bit of that food across there. Could be one of those things I never did anything with.
It's gotten very expensive. Again, I know it's character, but
yeah. I mean, everything's gotten expensive.
They do break some of those down and give some specifics. So, like for breakfast classics, they have Mickey waffles, Simba waffles, hard boiled eggs, overnight oats with berry compote, granola, fruit salad with ginger syrup, breakfast potatoes. The pastries, they have a zebra coffee cake, blueberry muffins, chocolate twist Danish, cream cheese Danish, cinnamon buns and bagels, bacon sausage patties, rotisserie ham, andouille sausage pieces.
We've been what, three times now? Twice, three times, whatever. But I can honestly say I think the Ale and Compass right now is best value on property.
What is?
Breakfast wise, Ale and Compass.
I've heard that too.
And again, it's only because of that buffet. You know, pick any entree for $23. Drink included.
Have you any boat rights? Not for breakfast, just boat rights in general.
I've never been.
We've stayed
at Riverside like four times already.
I was told that it's one of the best. It's family style. They have brisket and other stuff on there. Yeah. It's $39 a person for dinner.
Wow.
I can't attest that. It's just what I was told.
Okay.
No, Ale and Compass, again, and we're going again this year. We're going with Jeanette and Regina. And I think Jeff and Angela. No, Angela and Zach. But yeah, Ale and Compass, man, you can fill yourself. You can make a very large plate of the buffet section, which is biscuit and gravy, croissants, muffins,
and fruit.
The breakfast buffet, $23. It includes seasonal fruit, assorted yogurt parfaits, assorted breakfast pastries, house-made granola, cheddar biscuits, and country gravy, warm cinnamon rolls, and includes choice of one entree.
Yeah.
On top. Where's this at? Does it say Ale and Compass?
Ale and Compass.
Ale and Compass.
Oh, wow.
You can.
Stuff was a buffet, and then you get an entree with it?
Yeah. Yeah. And a drink. Juice or coffee or tea?
Yep. Tea, juice, coffee, soft drinks are included.
Yeah, whatever.
Chocolate milk?
Yeah. Yes, sir. I'll tell you, you can make a plate, and I saw Jeff do it. Too bad he's not here anymore, but I think I knocked him for it last week. The buffet plate that Jeff made at any Disney restaurant would have been $23 alone. That's how much food he put on that buffet plate.
Good night, Jill. And Janice says, yes, Ale and Compass breakfast is very good. The entrees
are great.
The entrees you've got are American breakfast, which is two eggs, any style, and sausage, bacon, potatoes.
Sure, that's that.
The dark chocolate waffle. The salted caramel apple French toast.
Ooh, that sounds good.
Shrimp and white cheddar grits. Smoked salmon with toasted bagel sandwich. Country ham and cheddar omelet. Crab cake Benedict.
Those are great.
Breakfast flatbread, which is sunny side egg, applewood smoked bacon, ham, provolone, and arugula. A breakfast protein bowl, and then a blueberry bacon pancakes.
That's what I was told was good right there.
Yeah, Jeff had that the other day.
It would either be that or the French toast, probably the only thing I would get.
French toast sounds amazing.
Chris, how much is the protein bowl? I think that's the most expensive.
The protein bowl is $20.
$20. So if you like protein bowls, for another $3, you get your drink, and you can go up to the buffet. As much as you want.
Oh, so it's not a. I thought you gave the price earlier. That was the buffet.
It is. And then I'm making my point. No. It's $23. My point is, if you were to go there, just order the protein bowl, for another $3, you get the buffet, and the drink.
Oh, you can eat an a la carte thing, is what you're saying.
Yeah.
Right. You can still order a la carte. You can say, I don't want to go to the buffet, but.
Well, yeah, that's crazy. Your drink's going to cost you more than $3.
Right.
Yeah.
Your coffee's $4.
I tend to always get the
crab cake Benedicts because I love crab cakes and I love egg Benedict. And that's what, like, I think 18.
The breakfast protein bowl and the shrimp and white cheddar grits are both $20 each. The crab cake Benedict is $19.
So $19. So it's stupid of me to be like, oh, I just want that. No. For another $4, I'm getting my buffet.
Is there bacon on the buffet?
No. It's not, and I try to tell people this, it's not a buffet. I mean, it's a buffet spread. You go up and get it. But again, like Chris just read, it's granola, it's parfaits. The only real food, and there's no meat to it, but it would be the biscuits and country gravy.
Yeah. And warm cinnamon rolls.
Oh, there's croissants. I get like three croissants, a whole bunch of butter. The muffins, there's like mini muffins, chocolate chip, blueberry. Oh, yeah, you can. I'm telling you, you can make a plate in itself. It'll be $23, and you're basically eating your meal for free. If you can eat that much food.
That's a crazy deal, because all the other ones that I've looked at are $43 or up for breakfast buffet.
I think Boma's breakfast was only $35. Is it higher now?
It's gone up. Yeah, it's $43 now. It went up. Yeah.
But it for $23, that sounds – I mean, I would pay that for the French toast and the drink, I think. So.
Yeah.
I might have to go try that.
Well, it's every day, so.
Andrew Bidding says carb toppings bar.
Yeah, pretty much.
Oh, overnight oats. Steve Browning said, Corey makes those. And they're the most disgusting thing I think I've ever smelled and tried in my entire life. You take like oats and stuff, you put milk in it, and you stick it in your cabinet, let it sit overnight. It almost ferments and curdles.
Andrew Bidding, what up, brother? Good to see you.
You put it in the fridge. Hey, Andrew.
The key is, I can't remember what he called it. It's like live culture. It's a grain. It's a type of grain. You put it in there. It's alive. And people grow it, and they share it with other people. Anyways, he throws it in there, and it's like alive, and it eats away the bad stuff. And then it like almost ferments it. It's, I don't know.
Spaceship Ears was wanting more details on the protein bowl. So it is a choice of tofu scramble or plant-based eggs with plant-based sausage, quinoa, sweet potatoes, charred kale, pickled carrots, served with carrot ginger dressing and chocolate avocado toast, plant-based.
Nothing I would pay $5 for, nonetheless, $20.
Exactly. Jan is leaving.
Good night, Jan. Have a good one.
So that's not regular. You read
protein bowl, and I would instantly think, okay, that's got like sausage or bacon or something. Right.
Yeah.
He said, okay, so it's a veggie protein bowl.
Exactly. Yes.
Yeah. Even the omelet. I've gotten the omelet a couple of times.
Okay, so these are completely different overnight oats somehow. So it's not the same thing as what I'm talking about then.
Yeah, for sure, we met Jeff, and yeah, that's right.
And Steve said they're refrigerated, so
yes, yeah,
so not what Corey's
not the cabinet refrigerated.
Yeah, here you go.
And we're at the beach club. We might go to Ellen Compass more than once.
Never had the Tonga toast that everybody
Suzanne has.
Overrated.
Where is that at?
Kona.
To be fair, though, like I said, I've not eaten a lot of breakfast there because we just don't eat breakfast. I think it's a waste of money. We'll bring Pop-Tarts or something, and that's, you know, bagels in the room and have a toaster, and we'll be fine with that. I think that price doesn't sound bad for a breakfast. But I think other than that and the occasional me eating at Boma because it's different, I don't think it's worth paying the money for breakfast.
I'll tell you, I'm kind of impressed with Alan Compass's lunch menu and all too. It's not bad priced either.
No, it's not. Price-wise, Alan Compass is not bad at all.
Lunch, you've got, looking at the main plates, you've got everything from fish and chips, blackened sustainable fish tacos, smoked salmon, and toasted bagel sandwich. All of those are $17. There's a grilled cheese sandwich with tomato soup for $15. Yes. There's a bacon and Vermont cheddar burger for $23.
I heard that's really good.
Seasonal market chicken sandwich for $16.
Ellen Compass is like Steakhouse 71. It's a upscale quick service. If you know what I mean, like If you can be in a park and be like, you could be in a park and be like, I'm gonna go get a burger at Starlight Cafe and pay 13, or I can walk over to Steakhouse 71 and get one for 17, and it's gonna be a lot better. Allen Compass is the same thing. You know, you can eat in the park at Epcot Hollywood Studios, or take the walk over to Allen Compass, get it a sit down, a nice place, and you're only paying a couple of bucks more.
If I'm going to be getting breakfast on property, it's usually going to be at Gaston's Tavern. Because for like $7, I can get that giant cinnamon roll, and it's one of the best things on property.
Yeah.
Suzanne still has
it. Chris, was it you that was telling me about Garden and Grill breakfast? Somebody told me Garden Grill had a really good breakfast with cinnamon rolls and stuff.
I will pull it up.
I don't like his Ohana breakfast. That is just bacon, sausage, eggs, and tater tots.
Where?
Ohana.
Ohana.
Yeah.
All right. So Garden Grill's breakfast is $47 for adults, $30 for kids. You have the Chip and Dale Harvest Feast, which is breakfast pastry, Mickey-shaped waffles, smoked bacon, skillet potatoes, fresh fruit, backyard grilled steak with Farmer's Ranchero sauce, and scrambled free-range eggs.
It must take cinnamon rolls off, but you get steak and bacon all you can eat?
Mm-hmm. They also have... that's allergy-free stuff. And then they have plant-based options as well.
It's unfortunate. I mean, we all have, well, not we all, but it's like my kids suck at eating. So it's you know, I can never, ever justify it. You know, I can't justify 1900. Michaela ain't going to touch anything. I want to pay $66 for Michaela to, you know, pick at a couple of things and be like, all right, I'm done.
Yeah.
I would think buffets, though, would be the way for them to go because they could find something they like and eat up on it.
Yeah, but even Ethan is crazy picky. And it's like,
he's worse than her.
He is worse than her. Like 1900, all he's going to eat is mac and cheese, and I pray to God it's on the menu
that's
somewhere.
That's all he ate at BOMA.
That's all he ate at BOMA. Yeah. That's all he ate at BOMA was mac and cheese. So I'm paying $30-something. No, he doesn't even pass for a kid anymore.
He won't pass for a kid anymore.
No, he's not. Well, he might. Only reason is, you know, you do your pre-check-in. They ask you for how many people and how many adults, how many kids. I put this one kid. You might get that one waitress that'll be like, all right, you know, I'll let it go. Or you can get that one, like, that kid's not 9. And then I'm screwed.
Yeah, your kid don't look 9 anymore.
No, not one bit. He's got a mustache and everything. So, no. You know, but I'm going to be like, well, he ate like an 8-year-old. Can I, you know, please help me? Yeah, we're Portuguese. We don't look young. We're ready to
eat. Carlos, there's no mac and cheese on that dinner menu.
Yeah, I know. I might be paying.
Maybe it's not there on the list.
For him to
and that's $66 per adult for dinner.
Yeah, I know it is. Thank you for reminding me. Appreciate it.
Chris, you're not helping. Mm-hmm.
Don't forget the fine print plus tax and tip.
Plus tax and tip and gratuity.
Yes.
Oh, don't worry.
If he was a kid, it would have only be 41. It would have saved you $20-$25.
Times 4, you know, minus 10% for your annual pass. Ooh, thank you.
Yeah, gratuity and everything are to be included because we have more than 6.
It's going to be included. Definitely. Who else is going? Who's going? Donna, Jeff, Angela,
Donna,
Arjun, Sam.
Me.
You. This, I think 2 more.
You only told me. Oh no, Baza or somebody?
Are they going? No, they're going. They're going. They're on the weekend. Barry and Maxine are with us all weekend long.
Like you told me.
So they're going. Suzanne has a list, but she's laying on it. Barry's going to Steakhouse, and he's going to 50s Prime. We're hoping you're there for 50s because the kids will be
there. Cry.
Yeah.
Although I didn't have any pull last time.
No, you didn't. No, it kind of worked out pretty shitty for us, actually. Steve's World. Great. We'll give it a worst case. I didn't swear. It's past midnight. If I say shit one more time, it is.
I got rid of that clip. I should have kept it. So I pulled up the bakery over in France.
Oh, so good.
Oh yeah.
I think I've never been here because I see most of these words and I have no idea what these words
are. You want me to translate? Go ahead and read
it. But good thing they have descriptions underneath each one. So they, for sandwiches, they've got a ham and cheese Dijon butter on a demi baguette. They have a croissant a la truffle, truffe, a ham and cheese and bechamel in a croissant. I don't know.
That was really good. I've had that.
Brie apples and cranberries in a multigrain bread. Turkey bacon, lettuce, tomato, and garlic aioli, BLT, and a chicken breast with cheese, tomato, red onion, and pesto.
Oh, what's the one I had that I have a picture of it. Oh, I'm on my phone. I can't show you. I got one of the turkey sandwiches. It was like a turkey club. And I swear they put one little strip of bacon in it. And when I mean, I mean, I even sent it to my boss because if you know what I do for a business, mm-hmm. I sent it to him. I says, don't ever be ashamed about the prices we charge and put, you know, and put in what we put in our breads, because look at this crap that I'm eating. The slice, I have the pictures. I'll find them. The turkey was rolled. It was like one slice of turkey rolled, one strip of bacon. The most thing that I had in my sandwich was the lettuce.
You can get a half of a baguette for $2.75 or a full baguette for $3.95.
Yeah, but Chris, a full baguette, I mean, it's a baseball bat, buddy.
Yeah. That's what I'm saying, but just $3.95, that's...
Oh, yeah, it's a steal. And you get a half one with a soup. If you order a soup, they give you a half one. The lobster bisque is really good.
We took the bread and the kids ate it.
Yeah, we took the bread and the kids were eating it around the
lobster bisque in a bread bowl. That sounds good.
Yeah, that was good.
Bacon and cheese roll. They have a ham gruyere quiche. Toasted ham and cheese.
That's good.
We've
had a lot of things there.
Egg, cheese, and bacon croissant. That's probably what you were talking about a minute ago. An apple crumble pastry. That sounds amazing.
That does sound good.
Chocolate croissant with almond filling.
Yeah, we always get the same dessert, a creme brulee and a chocolate mousse.
Yeah. Demi baguette is like a demi bras. It's half there.
Oh, man.
Well, I think it's time we'll call it a night.
Oh.
Because I'm really hungry now. appreciate y'all hanging out with us. Sorry about no name that movie, but it'll be here next week. We'll do it then.
My niece wants to play, so. We might have a stranger on stream.
There we go. Appreciate everybody, all the fun. Thank you to Tina for joining us. Tracy and Kenzie were here. Jeff is our dream. Be sure to follow Jeff tomorrow morning over at Animal Kingdom, bright and early at 8:00. Snickerdoodle will be on with the late. Sty, welcome in. Hey. It's early, Si. Have a good night.
Actually, she's probably just
waiting. Snickerdoodle will be on with the Triple C's tomorrow night over on Pete's channel at 6:00. And we may be back here tomorrow night.
It's movie night.
Movie night.
So, are we going to watch a movie this time?
We may. We'll talk about that.
Okay.
So hope you have a good night. We'll see you in the streams. Hopefully see you back here tomorrow night. Take care. Joy will be live Wednesday night at 8 o'clock. And we'll see you real soon. Love you all. And yep, that's it. Talk to you soon. Bye, doodles.